Peekaboo, motherfuckers. Good evening, good morning, good whatever, you dragon fuckers. Okay, so we are going to play Angels with Scaly Wings, a visual novel about dating dragons. So, yeah, that's going to be rather interesting. So, I'm actually really excited to play this game because my good friend Nightsky has bought it for me, actually, which is pretty fucking sweet. Really appreciate it, dude. Thank you very much. So we're going to be playing that. There's still playing guitar. Did I give up? I haven't given up yet. I just lack the motivation at the moment, but I'm working on that. So hopefully pretty soon we'll get back into that. So first thing, I would like to show this. Because Nightsky posted in the discussions on the official Steam page for the game, and he placed my stream there. Now, and he made the title Steaming this game. So what I whipped up is this. I whipped up the game being fucking steamed. I thought that was pretty fucking funny, so just wanted to show you guys that. I think it's pretty hilarious. Okay, so without further ado, we are going to get right into the game. Just boot up my Steam. Might be fucking clever, right? So I have no idea what to expect out of this game, to be quite honest. It's apparently very good, very feelsy, and I quite enjoy that. So we'll have to see what's going to be up. Them puns are real? Well, of course. Apparently there's a free weekend for Rainbow Six Siege. Well, problem is I already have Rainbow Six Siege. Steaming. It's hilarious. Okay. Let me see, does it actually work? Yes, it does! Hang on, I think there's supposed to be like an intro to this. Okay, so when you quit it, it apparently just fucking crashes. Let me see if this works. There we go. Angels with Scaly Wings. Glorious typos. Yes. Ooh, a portal. Sweet. You are an ambassador. Like that cup? Teleported to a strange land. Something's up with this place. Oh, a murder! Explore a town full of secrets. Woo! Shinigami! That's one of the Dragon Priest masks. And the people who keep them. Like that cup? My cup is glorious, dude. We have Remy, Adine, Anna, Bryce, and holy crap, a lot more. With the composer for the Zero Escape series? Sweet! Okay, so that's the intro to the game. That's pretty neat, actually. Okay, since this game doesn't have voice acting, you guys are gonna have to listen to me. I'm gonna be the voice actor for this game, okay? That's gonna be fucking fun. That's gonna be the most amazing thing ever, believe me. Okay, so we're just gonna jump straight in. Detecting user profile. We don't have a user profile. Fuck! You kill dragons in Skyrim? Of course. Please enter your name. Well, of course, we are going to be called Settlemore. No, just kidding. I for this game, I'm going to just put in, you know, regular old metalcore. Choose a color. Blue, red, yellow, green, gray. Show more. You have cyan, magenta, lime, orange, white. Gold, silver, brass, bronze, copper. Olive, brown, teal, purple, maroon. Kind of like the maroon. Let's go with maroon. That maroon looks nice. Does this look right? I think that looks pretty good. Yes. User profile confirmed. Good. Yeah, yes, voice actor. Oh boy. Prepare for cringeworthiness, bro. Please review the following information. Okay, this is... Okay, so we should probably use space just to only advance the text. Okay, cool. Cool, cool. Escape, right-click, blinkers to the menu, F toggles full screen, review past messages, and rewind. To skip scene messages, S takes a screenshot, middle click hides the text window. Okay, that would be all. Thank you! The year is 20XX. 20-something. Only recently has humanity discovered a portal that leads into a different world, populated with a race of intelligent talking dragons. I was one of the few to travel to this world. But maybe I should start at the beginning. It all began when we discovered a strange device in the middle of nowhere during one of our expeditions. A portal. Ooh! Mystery, I like it. I had heard about similar technology before, though that had been more on an experimental level. From what I knew, other portals had been created in the past and were under consideration for mass application. As for this one in particular, though, we did not know who had built it, nor when, or why we found it in the wilderness where we did. What was more exciting for us was the fact that it was, well, functional. Did I play Resident Evil? No, I don't. Sorry. After our first test, we found there was someone else on the other side who was in possession of a similar portal, and our attempts at communication through letters were successful. But in the end, the machine's extraordinary demand for power meant we needed to act quickly, as we wouldn't be able to keep the portal open much longer. When we made this known to the other side, we received a very unexpected reply, a letter of invitation. After some deliberation, it was decided to accept their hospitality and send a person to the other side. That would probably be me. There was an individual who took the job almost immediately. That person is me! Ya boy! Reza Izquierdo. Holy shit. Oh, that's not me. Damn it. I knew him, or rather, had known him. We attended the same school and even had a few classes together. We never really were very close friends, but we talked to each other occasionally and hung around with the same crowd sometimes. However, we still went our separate ways in the end. I wasn't sure what to think about the whole thing, but he had to have known what he was doing. He certainly was brave. Either that or just very, very foolish. I mean, yeah, probably. While I wasn't sure which, his courage was applauded by others. After all, he couldn't possibly have known who or what would await him at the other end of the portal. And if he did meet someone there, who knew what kind of intentions they might have. They're going to kidnap and rape me! Now! Not that any speculation on our part would have made a difference. When the day finally came, through he went, with applause echoing across the area, equipped only with the clothes he wore, his multi-tool, a gun, and a device on his wrist that acted as a PDA. Then we waited. The crowd that was applauding him slowly dispersed when the enthusiasm died down, as there was nothing for us to do but wait and speculate. Approximately 8 hours later, we received our first message from him. While we had assumed the portal led to another in a different country, or maybe on a different continent, the reality turned out to be much more foreign. The situation he described to us was so outlandish that we initially took it as a joke. A very bad joke, maybe, with even worse timing and no punchline at all. It soon became clear to us, though, that we may have just made one of the most important discoveries since the dawn of mankind. Finding the portal had been remarkable in itself, but this took it to a completely different level. From what he described about the place, or more accurately, its inhabitants, we surmised it could not be part of Earth at all. We called them dragons because, according to Reza, that's what they were, or at least what they resembled most. Even though we found it hard to believe, these dragons who sent us all the letters. And what Reza found on the other side of the portal was a whole civilization of them. They could talk, write books, had buildings and electricity. In many ways, their society was actually very similar to our own. So who were they? And where was this place? Could they be aliens? Our speculations led us to conclude otherwise. After all, we knew about the existence of thousands of planets, millions of light years away that may have been theoretically habitable. Yet even then, we had never found conclusive proof in regards to actual alien life forms. Very true. Some people brought up quantum mechanics and parallel universes, but in the end, all of this was just conjecture and an ultimately fruitless endeavor, since we neither had the means nor the resources to explore these possibilities in greater detail. I think there's just one more thing worth mentioning before I move on. The previous isolation had been mutual. They hadn't known about any other intelligent life form beyond their own. Their portal had only recently been discovered and was a technology previously unknown to them. And just as we had myths about dragons, they had myths about us. That was what we knew about them so far, and as interesting as learning those things and debating their cultural significance was, we didn't really know what we should make of it all. Rezo apparently was sure of what he was doing, though, as he eventually let us know that they had agreed on a trade. We were to give them a few of our PDA devices, which contained vast amounts of knowledge, dwarfing even that of encyclopedias. In return, they would supply us with generators. Overall, they didn't seem as technologically advanced as we had been, but they did surpass us in that aspect. Their means of generating energy seemed sustainable. Not only that, but evidently also quite efficient. We certainly would be able to put technology like that to good use, and trading mere past knowledge of the human race for something more tangible was a good call on his part. I mean, you can do a lot of things with knowledge. Just share my garage. Share with my brand new Lamborghini. But you know what I like more than my brand new Lamborghini? Knowledge. That's why I have this case of books. I read one book every day. hilarious. And that was where I came in. My prior experience in both biology and sociology made me a good fit to deliver our PDA devices for the trade. And while in the dragon's world waiting for the prototypes of our generators to be manufactured by them, I would act as an ambassador on humanity's behalf. What a way to make a first impression by a display of mutual goodwill. Everyone benefits and everyone goes home happy. All is well. At least, that was the plan. Despite the images that living talking dragons might conjure up in some people's minds, I didn't even think of bringing a weapon myself, considering they were reportedly friendly and peaceful enough. There was no need for me to fear potential ill intentions like Reza did when he had stepped into unknown territory and acting as humanity's ambassador. I had to do my best to uphold a high standard in fostering this diplomatic relationship. When the time came for me to step through the portal, all my mental preparedness vanished. My anxiousness was fueled by all the questions lurking in my head, just as the machine started to do its work. Would it hurt? Who would I meet on the other side? What if they really weren't so friendly and just made Razor write these letters, with the pretense of appearing friendly, only to lure us into the den of man-eating monsters and certain doom, with us ending up as nothing more than a tasty afternoon snack? That would be a really dick move, by the way. Jesus. Maybe I should have brought a weapon after all. Suddenly, I felt a shiver coursing throughout my whole body, and beyond when I disintegrated, as if every cell, every atom of my body was torn from me and pulled into a different direction. That must be weird, dude. We're powering up. No, I'm not gonna turn Super Saiyan. I saw darkness and light, painting patterns in the stars as I traveled, and images rapidly flashed before me of things unseen and unspoken, both horrifying and beautiful. It was an experience unlike any other, yet over in just a split second. Then it was dark, and the light was no more. Our main character has died. Rest in peace. It didn't go very well. I could only see a patch of lighter color contrasting with its dark surroundings as my vision started to clear. Its edges got sharper as the patch of light slowly took shape, giving me the distinguished outline of a reptilian head and an array of horns spouting from it. Hello? Are you my mommy? This fucker is wearing a lap suit and a tie. It was a dragon! And as I could now see, a dragon who not only had a pair of round glasses, but also wore a burgundy tie around its neck. I mean, at least the book is classy. Hang on, I have just... one thing I need to check real quick. Okay. Rip. In the name of our people, I bid you welcome. If I may introduce myself, I am Remy, your guide and ambassador, a representative of our council. The dragon spoke. It was one thing to have heard and read about this, but something else entirely to have one standing in front of me, in flesh and blood and tongue. It was good that all my mental preparedness had disappeared when I was teleported, because nothing could have prepared me for this. Yeah, no, I would probably be a little off-put as well, just like, okay, it's actually a talking dragon. Sorry, I imagine you might still feel the effects of the teleportation. Drowsiness or weakness is not unusual, as is fainting and spontaneous emptying of your bowels. Bladder or stomach, how do you feel? There's a lot of lampshade hanging in this game? The fuck does that mean? Rendered speechless, I had totally forgotten that I was shouldering the burden of representing my people to them as well. So much for being professional, but at least he gave me a good excuse for my blunder. I think I'm alright. I hope so. Well, I'm glad to hear that. Maybe we should go before it gets too dark. Come with me, please. Don't tell me we're gonna get creepers and shit. No! So I followed the dragon, not straying too far from him, as the sun had already departed for the day, and the remaining light diminished by the minute. It's getting hard to see where I'm going. Sorry about that, but we had a good reason to schedule your arrival like this. We did not want you to be ambushed by a crowd, so we had to keep your exact time and arrival date of arrival secret. Thanks. I suppose an event like this would make me a celebrity of sorts. It would be the same if one of you came to us. That's quite an understatement. Some people here are rather superstitious. They might regard you or any of your kind as divine, I suppose. Ah, yes, humanity in its infinite stupidity, that which we do not understand must of course come from the high heavens above. Even though 99.999, if not 100% of the time, there's a completely rational explanation for it. Seems like that has also been paralleled in this universe. Can never get away from human stupidity, can you? Really? How so? We do have certain myths that involve humans and the such. Oh, I suppose the history lesson will have to wait for another time. Here we are. By this point, it had gotten so dark that I could barely make out the building before us. I briefly wondered whether they might have streetlights everywhere elsewhere, or if they just did not require any due to possible enhanced eyesight or night vision. I could vaguely see the dragon, his light colors still visible within the blackness that engulfed the area, rear up and manipulate the door handle with one of his forepaws. So, no magic. Darn. Oh, this is a quaint little house. Hinges creaking, the door opened, and with the flick of a switch, the apartment was flooded with light, blinding me after all the time we had just spent without it. This is where you will live for the time being. It is fully stocked, but in case you need anything else, I left you a note with a few phone numbers. Ah, so they are advanced enough to have phones. Interesting. It is getting rather late, so I will have to take my leave now. In any case, someone will come and meet you tomorrow morning. Thank you, Remy. Have a good night. Until we meet again. With a nod, Remy left the apartment, mindful enough to close the door behind himself. Surveying the room, I considered the events that had just transpired as my gaze met the window. I could see movement outside, and as I drew nearer, startled, I could hear footsteps in the grass, moving away quickly. Assuming it must have been the dragon I just met, I thought nothing of it as I went to bed and slowly succumbed to the sweet allure of sleep overdue. That is quite foolish, because why would he be just, you know... why would he just run away, just like, fuck it, Al, run! I would be a little bit more suspicious. It's like, who's this fucker? Show yourself! I spent a few moments thinking about my role, my mission, and what it meant to be here now. Okay, so we can either feel the responsibility placed on our shoulders or eager for the adventure to come. Well, can I not do both? Because, I mean, you know, two birds of a feather. I mean, we're going to be adventurous here. So many possibilities and prospects raced through my mind. Truth be told, the thought of being able to meet an entirely new species and civilization excited me, as I was going to be one of the first to truly experience their society with its own little quirks, differences, and similarities. I couldn't help but feel like some sort of modern Vasco da Gama or Marco Polo. Maybe I would even write a book about the whole experience after it's all over. I was sure it would become a hit, all things considered. Yeah. At any rate, this is going to be fun. Sweet. Oh, Jesus! Chapter 1, Inception. Oh boy, here we go! Ah, that's making me tired. Damn it! I awoke from uneasy dreams, looking at an unfamiliar ceiling. Just for a moment, I wondered where I was before the events of last night all came back to me. After a good stretch, I looked around the room, illuminated by the sunlight coming in from the window. Outside, in the distance, the portal I had emerged from proudly stood on the peak of a small hill. Getting ready, I noticed something lying on the table. It was the note Remy had left for me, in case I needed anything. Along with his own home phone and work number, there were also some numbers for delivery of food and other necessities, as well as emergency and even janitorial services. He had certainly thought of everything, even though I now had to wonder what a dragon plumber might look like. Yeah, that would look rather interesting. I'm kind of curious now as well. Can we dial that number? My musings were interrupted when the doorbell rang. When I opened the door, I was met by another dragon. Oh, look at this fucker blushing. Is that a blush I see? Hello. You must be Metalcore. I'm Sebastian, and I'll be your escort. Or security, I suppose. Usually I work for the police, though. Nice to meet you. He seemed a lot smaller than Remy, and when he somewhat nervously extended his arm towards me, I noticed he apparently only walked on his hind legs, the two forelimbs instead having distinct arms, hands, and fingers. Okay, so you can shake his hand, don't shake. We can kiss his hand! Ah. Oh boy. Kissing his hand would be the funniest fucking thing. This motherfucker is so goddamn nervous, and what you do, you fucking kiss him on the hand. That would probably break him. He would just shut down, full reboot. No, we'll shake the fucker's hand. I mean, kissing his hand, we'll do that in later playthroughs. I mean, I am gonna play through this game until I have everything. So we'll get to doing that eventually, don't worry. Ugh. When I took his hand into mine to shake it gently, I could feel the individual bumps and scales on his rough skin. Nice to meet you too, Sebastian. So where are you taking me? Straight to business, eh? We're going to visit the plant where they are making your generators. They have some news for you, or so I've heard. Reza will be there too. Sounds great. Just follow me. Okay, sweet. No bullshit, no nothing, just straight to the point. While we walked, I was under the impression we were purposely avoiding the busier parts of town, instead straying towards the edges and smaller alleys as not garnered too much attention. Even then, we got the occasional stare. I mean, yeah, people probably everyone else probably doesn't know what the fuck I even am. Just like, what the fuck is that fucking thing? Will it bite me? Will it pee on my carpet? One thing is telling me that's not quite right. You see, I'm doing just a regular thing, so whatever. After just a couple of minutes, we arrived at our destination, where we were met by Reza, as well as yet another dragon. A vicious-looking beast that didn't stay too close to him. Oh, Jesus! Holy crap, he's huge! Hey! Reza, long time no see. How true that is. Good to finally see another human face around here. What a coincidence to have you, of all people, show up. Yeah, I guess those degrees aren't so useless after all. By the way, who's your friend? Just my bodyguard. Same as you. Same as yours. Don't bother with him. He doesn't talk much. It's a hairless monkey wearing cloth. Nah, bro, that's just racist, man. Come on. So just like you, then. Very funny. The two dragons exchanged a few words as I met the gaze of the larger, tenebrous dragon a few paces from us. Sebastian turned towards me and spoke up again. Hey, Metalcore, this is Maverick. Nice to meet you. Yeah, whatever. Just don't expect me to give you any special treatment like everyone else is, and we'll be good. What are you talking about? So you're saying you haven't noticed the stairs and how they all treat you like you're the next messiah or something? No, I just thought... We're not the ones making a big deal out of this, you are. We're just here to get what we agreed on and then we'll be gone. If anything, I'd prefer if you let us alone, but you're the one who insists on following me around wherever I go. A growl escaped the darker dragon's trembling lips as he bared his teeth at Reza. Hang on, I need to... Can I turn this down a little bit? I can barely hear myself talk! Better. It was getting a little bit loud, so... Alright, that's quite enough. Let's just all go inside already, shall we? After you. Probably not the best idea giving us a hothead as a fucking bodyguard. The crisis was quickly averted as we entered the building, which was characterized by its many floors, high ceilings, and long, narrow hallways as Sebastian led us to our destination. There you are. I was waiting for you. This is a female, 100%. She looks kind of like a velociraptor, to be quite honest. Wait a minute, I thought we were going to be the guys from production. What are you doing here? They're only coming later in the day, so you'll have to make do with me. I see. Well, Metalcore, this is Anna. She kind of manages this building, though actually she's more involved with the research wing rather than production and engineering. Nice to meet you. My pleasure. I have something for you, by the way. It'll take them a while to make all the generators we promised, but we've got one for you here. Feel free to send it home and give it a test. That's great, I'll take it! Riz is just like, fuck it, mine! Looks a little small if you ask me. Don't underestimate its power. Oh, and do be careful not to drop it. Sure, I'll be waiting outside while you do your thing, Metalcore. This is like, yoink, mine! I suppose I'll wait for you outside as well. What thing? Oh, have you brought the PDA? Well, of course, here you go. Alright, now to give this thing a test run. The PDA lit up as her hand swiftly moved around its interface in calculated motions. By the way, would you consider letting me run some tests on you as well? It would only take a drop of your blood. Like, oh god, are you gonna undress me? Are we gonna go straight there? Are we gonna go straight to that? I mean, can't you at least buy me fucking dinner first? What? Why? I work in biology, so obviously this kind of thing would be very interesting to us. I'd share the results with you, of course. Well, I mean, sure, the more knowledge, the better. Great! She was quick to produce a small device from a drawer, which, from a glance, reminded me a lot of a test tube. Now, if you would give me your hand, please. I see that sly look! I see that! I fucking see that! Don't you start! As I reached out to her, she took my hand in hers before she pressed the device into the back of my hand. I winced as pain jolted through my hand. Something sharp drove itself through my skin, and shortly afterwards, a droplet of blood was sucked into the tube attached to the smaller needle. Thanks. You're welcome? You gave Anna your blood, and I got an achievement. Blood donation. There it is. Looks like PDA is good, by the way, so we're just about done here. And since we're both in biology, it could be interesting if you want us to meet, if you want to meet me some other time as well. Here's my number. Oh god, I'm already picking up the dragon ladies. Oh god. I haven't even done anything yet. Alright. See you soon. Oh, I fucking see that. I see that. Don't you deceive me. That's fucking... Okay. It's gonna be like this, huh? Well, that was interesting. I completely agree. Did she ask you for your blood too? Yeah. Did you give it to her? Yes. I see no reason to lie. Oh, well, it's your choice. We've got no idea what they might do with it, though. I'm getting hungry. How about some breakfast? I'm all for it. Can't stand early mornings like this. That shouldn't be a problem. There's a cafe not far from here. What do you say, Mavers?
Wouldn't mind to grab a bite myself.
Well, that settles it then. Onwards! Luckily for us, the cafe was mostly empty when we arrived, as it was still pretty early in the day. Razor was quick to lead me to a table for two, prompting the dragons to get one of their own at the other side of the restaurant. Ugh, finally! I can't stand that guy being on my tail all the damn time. I mean, you're talking about tails and you're not even a fucking dragon. I'm gonna joke it up with this guy. Maybe he just likes you a lot. We were approached by an individual who appeared to be the waitress at the cafe. She was an interesting looking dragon who, unlike the others I had seen so far, was more akin to a weaven, possessing two rather large wings as her forelimbs, which resembled those of an oversized bat. Oh, it's the humans. Wait, where? That's a good one. Welcome to our establishment. My name is Adine, and I'll be your waitress for today. What can I bring you to? Well, today's fucking special, so let's... Yeah, me too. Just make it quick. I mean, we're gonna go for something good here. I mean, we've just met up with a whole new species, and we're trading shit, so let's do something good. Sure thing, two specials coming right up. As I was saying, if you look at the big picture, don't you think there's just something off about the whole place? Where it is, really? If this is supposed to be a completely separate place from Earth or even a different dimension, some things just don't add up. Don't you think so too? Oh, we live in a strange universe. Let me just grab my tinfoil hat real quick. I've been here much longer than you've been. Maybe you'll see soon enough. Can't really say much more with you know who over there. He's probably listening to us right now. Yeah, he's a charming fellow. When I let my gaze wander, I saw that Maverick was looking in my direction. Our eyes met briefly, his expression not showing any discernible emotion. Well, I wondered whether it had been just a coincidence or if he really was able to hear us from the distance. I do have some theories, and if I'm right, we might be in trouble. What kind of trouble? What might you be talking about? Shh, be quiet. I'll let you know more as soon as I can, but for now, let's just play along. After all, we already have one of these babies. He patted the generator's box for emphasis. God knows we need them. Well, there she comes. The female returned, astounding me with her ability to balance the dishes on the edge of her wings. She placed her forelimbs on the table and proceeded to move the dishes from her wing with a gentle push of her snout. There you go. Watch out. It's hot. Just like you, baby. Now shoe scaly face. Now that's rude. That's fucking rude, man. Don't go hurting around a female's feelings like that. You're welcome. Apparently today's special consisted of an odd-looking fish of some sort. I was a little bit hesitant to try it, but considering the steam coming from it, it was probably better to wait a few minutes anyway. When the waitress brought out meals to the two dragons across the cafe and exchanged a few words with them, Risa leaped forward and whispered something to me.
I'll send you a letter with a coded message later. You'll know what to do.
Rosa, blah, 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 blah. I need a drink. More alcohol! Even though this is 7-Up. Whatever. Reza rose from his seat before he made it known to me that he still had a few things to do and left the restaurant, followed shortly after by the larger of the two dragons. Yeah. But you haven't even touched your fish. I wasn't in a hurry, so I spent a few more minutes in contemplation while I looked at the window. Not that this whole situation was already bizarre enough, there was also now the vague sense of danger conveyed by Reza's earlier words. I didn't even have an idea what kind of threat might be lurking out there. Eventually, I took a bite of my somewhat unusual breakfast. While I already thought the smell was quite peculiar, the taste had been even worse. I imagined it might be the kind of delicacy that had an acquired taste. One that I certainly hadn't acquired yet. I decided to get outside before it was too late. Are you done? Sure am. How'd you like it? I'll just say it's probably not for me. And you wouldn't be the only one to say that. You better wait outside just in case it decides to come up again. You tried the odd-looking fish. You now have bravery. Sure thing. Now... I stepped outside, taking in the scenery of this strangely familiar world. In the short time I was here, I had already found the similarities between their world and our own utterly fascinating. After all, we were talking about an unmapped place with a never-before-seen form of life. As far as discoveries were concerned, even something as simple as a new unicellular organism or even bacteria would have been remarkable. Yet, here I was, standing in the middle of a village evidently built by this race of intelligent talking dragons with a society not unlike our own. Reza didn't seem to share the same interest and instead was more smitten with the generator, but given our reasons for coming here in the first place, I couldn't blame him for his enthusiasm being focused on something else. My thoughts were interrupted as something suddenly zipped past me just a little too close, causing me to stumble back. It was a rather small dragon with a bag clamped in its maw who apparently had somewhere to be.
Look out, asshole! You fucking...
It's a pink dragon, though. I regained my footing and watched as it disappeared into the distance, even though I'd seen enough dragons to recognize their variations in color, in size, color, and other attributes. I guess this one must have been a juvenile of its species. Shortly afterwards, Sebastian joined me outside, having taken care of the tab. I gave her a generous tip on your behalf. I hope you don't mind. Actually, I do, you fucking dickhole! In any case, now that you've given us the PDA and Reza has the generator, you're free for today, so... If you want to go anywhere in particular, let me know, or I could show you around town. I was tempted to be given a tour, but considering Reza's words, I wanted to be careful and not stray too far without knowing much more about this world first. I think I'll stay home for the day. I still have to get used to everything, you know? I'll just accompany you back then. There we are. Home sweet home. For now, at least. Well, if you need anything, I'll be outside until my shift ends. Otherwise, I'll see you tomorrow. Thanks. See you tomorrow. See ya. I hadn't really looked at the apartment much, so I spent the rest of the day investigating it and relaxing.
I consider checking out some of the phone numbers Remy had left me, but I thought it was better to keep a low profile for now. I found the kitchen fully stocked with plenty of groceries, though the variety was wasted on me. I hadn't been a particularly great cook in the first place, but what was more, I didn't even recognize some of the things I found in there. Yeah, shut up. Whether they were edibles that we had back home that I just didn't know about, or something completely alien, I wasn't sure. But I didn't want to take the risk of eating anything I didn't know. After all, it was possible that some of the comestibles might be fine for them to eat, but still be poisonous to us. I was also glad to find a shelf that was filled to the brim with a variety of books. While I found the subject matter of man, myth, or reality to be quite intriguing, I had given up after just a few pages due to its exceptionally dry writing style, which I wasn't inclined to enjoy at the moment. Chromatic Scales is just putting out the song titles, holy shit. In the end, I settled for an adventure novel about a dragon archaeologist who stumbles upon the remains of a long-lost human civilization, after which he is hunted by an evil organization who wants to use the found magic artifacts for its own nefarious purposes. So basically, this world's Indiana Jones. While entertaining, I had to admit that it reminded me a little too much of the trashy novels we had at home. I certainly found it amusing that certain tropes were not really unique to us as a species. Though I wondered whether this kind of literature had fallen into disfavor here as it had back where I had come from. Excuse me, Jesus. I was reading a particularly exciting scene in which the hero, Sheridan, uses one of the magical artifacts shaped like a pair of human hands holding a scepter with a globe at the top to prevent her from being crushed and ground to a bloody pulp by an ancient human temple's moving walls, when I suddenly heard the doorbell ring. Ding dong. And who might this be? Well, I haven't seen you before. Didn't sleep much? Well, no, I've slept plenty, I'm just a bit tired. Hello there, would you please sign here? I'm not signing away my rights with this, am I? Well, I've got a letter for you that requires signature confirmation. I see. Looking over the clipboard the small dragon was holding up to me, I saw that the sender of the letter in question was Reza. Well, there you go. I'm Lauren, by the way. Would you mind if I asked you a few questions? What is this about? I'm just making small talk. Wait a minute, I recognize you. You tried to do the same thing with Reza. I should report you to your superiors for your inappropriate behavior towards your clients. But it's important. Please, just let me talk to MetalCore for a few minutes. No! You're not allowed! Fuck you! Know how it is, if you want an interview with one of the humans, you have to get permission from the proper authorities. Help me out here, MetalCore. As an ambassador, you care about the accurate portrayal of humans in the media, don't you? Then you should talk to me. Otherwise, someone else will fill in the blanks, and who knows what they will come up with. Let me show you something. The small dragon opened his bag, rummaging through a number of letters and small packages. Huh, I think I lost it. Anyway, I wanted to show you some pictures of what people think humans look like. On some of them, they have like four heads and look nothing like you. It's crazy. What are you, Lorem, a reporter? No, I'm just... Do you want me to remove a metal core? Is what he is saying true? Yeah, I guess. I see. That sounds pretty interesting, though. Alright, can you leave your number here, and maybe I'll call you later, but that's all I can promise. I don't know, I'm getting messages. Oh boy! And there's nothing fucking important. Damn it! He quickly produced a small sheet of paper and scribbled his number on it. Afterwards, he sheepishly presented it with both hands. Alright, you got what you wanted. Off you go now. And bye! Sorry about that. Don't worry about it. I guess that should be all. I'll see you tomorrow then. Right. With all the commotion, I almost forgot that I was also still holding Reza's letter. And before, you know, anthrax. Within the plain envelope was a similarly plain sheet of paper with his handwriting. When I started reading, however, I saw that his wording was so full of the pleasantries I knew he hated, that I assumed every word of it was faked, as to conceal his true intent. He did mention I'd know what to do, but I was unsure of how I was supposed to decode the letter's secret message. I didn't remember ever having a conversation about this topic with him, yet he still relied on me to remember whatever it was that I was missing, or he thought I would just be able to figure it out on my own. Yeah, I fucking hope you can remember. This is what it said. Hello, my dear friend. I hope this letter reached you swiftly and in good condition. Unfortunately, we were not able to catch up earlier, so I wanted to write you this letter. How have you been these last few years? What have you been doing? How's the family? I feel like there is so much we could talk about, we should talk about, since we have not seen each other much recently. At least we have a chance to do so in this form. Quite an exciting adventure are we are on now, right? How have you liked it here so far? Made any dragon friends yet? Haha. Anyways, I'll be looking forward to your reply soon. Best regards, Reza. Various things came to mind. Only reading certain words or letters was one of that I thought of immediately, but I couldn't make out anything after trying to find a system within its array of letters and lines. Maybe I had to look more carefully. Maybe read between the lines? Lines, of course. Maybe I was supposed to read between them? I didn't have an implement on me with which I would be able to read fine print. Though with this handwritten letter, I doubted Razor could have done anything of the sort. Well, look elsewhere. Or maybe we refer to the fact that we were both given an apartment. Considering the things they have provided for us, maybe I just have to find the right object to decode the message. There were many everyday items here, though, and of course I still had no idea what in particular I was looking for. In the kitchen. Look in the fridge. Plenty of stuff in here. Crack open one of the eggs. Slab of meat. Pasteurized. At least they've got that down. Amen. Some white liquid inside. Well, here goes nothing. It's salty. You drank a mystery liquid. I am apparently a daredevil. Sweet! Look at the pantry. Just some fruit and veggies. So, about books in it, scan to boot chip, enlightenment under. Expression meaning someone who shows the fig, which is a bulk just that I don't give a fig, which of course is a figure of speech. For reaching its fruit succulent, figuratively speaking, that is. Oh, this, hey, we got one of those guys. I kind of like you now. I hope the raised letter though. Pear. What a nice pear. So daddy great, find his kid crying and asks, what's wrong, kid? He went straight to the kitchen, he's more genius than I am. Oh, some of the- that's- don't backseat fucking play this game, you bitch! So, Daddy Grape finds this kid crying and asks, what's wrong, kid? But through all the tears, the kid couldn't get a single word out. Eventually, Daddy had enough, so he said, stop, why- no, I would say it. It wasn't a good joke, anyway. I did press I know what to do, and it was a mistake. You learned a lot about fruits. I am now a fruitarian. Lol, 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 lol. Main character really loves figs. Yeah. Look at the lemon. Of course, lemon can be used to show coded messages. Lemons. Lemons. Lemons, of course! Why didn't I realize it sooner? Yeah, lemon juice can actually unveil hidden messages. Lemon juice is just about the simplest way to write a hidden message using household items. We learned about that in chemistry. In the most boring detail, of course. A message written in lemon juice on paper becomes just about invisible to the naked eye when dried. But after heating it gently, oxidation occurs, making the message visible. Of course! I was sitting next to him in class when we learned that. He made a joke about using the method to cheat on the next test, and I replied by saying he'd have to bring an iron. Had he really expected me to remember a random chemistry class that happened years ago? But then I did remember it after all. Meet me at the portal tonight, 10 PM, was all the message said. I wasted a good... this is making me puke. Oh boy, here we go. But I still had some time left before I'd have to go out to meet Reza, so I decided to make some lunch. Afterwards, I resumed reading my book about the continuing adventures of Sheridan and her exploits in destroying cultural artifacts. Yeah. Unsurprisingly, it came to a happy end, with the evil organization stopped in its tracks, at least for now. I thought the ending was deliberately left open for ambiguity, but when I turned the page and saw the advertisement for the next entry in this apparently long-running series of books, I realized all of this had just been a ploy to set up the inevitable sequel. So yeah, basically Indiana Jones. Luckily, the disappointment didn't last long as I had to get going to meet Reza at the portal. Good God, talking a lot like this is hell on your voice. When I got outside, it didn't seem quite as dark as it was when I arrived yesterday. I might have had difficulties finding my way otherwise, but I could still see the portal in the distance. Hello? As I was walking, I wondered if anyone was following me, but the land seemed oddly deserted. Was everyone really asleep? Who the fuck knows? They might be looking at me with a sniper rifle fucking locked onto my head so they could just, you know, fucking edit the moment I find anything out. Or, you know, they could just swoop down from above and just fucking burn me alive. Eventually, I arrived at my destination. Reza was already standing idly by the portal, his fidgeting making it obvious that he had waited just for me. I was already wondering whether you'd get it at all. I guess I did. What a wonderful night it is. Just look up at the stars. You can see them so clearly here, without all the pollution lingering in the air like back home. Almost as if we were looking right into the face of eternity itself. You know, I would like to see a proper starry sky once, because the thing is, I live in the middle of a fucking city, and close to a major city, so... You know, light pollution is a bitch. So I kind of want to go and see a proper starry sky one day. Just get away from everything as far as you can. So like you can see the sky properly. For so long, humanity thought we'd find aliens out there. Yet after all these years, we found that we were still alone in the universe. Well, turns out we were just not looking in the right place. What's going on, Reza? Why did you call me here at this time? Well, for one, because we're sending the generator home. Right. Before I was sent here, they told me that they would limit the use of the portal, as they couldn't afford to keep it open all the time. In order to keep contact with us and to enable us to send things over to them, the portal would be open for just a quarter of an hour each day. Sending something back home wasn't really problematic for us, since the high energy expenditure associated with sending bigger objects only affected the sender, not the receiver. However, this also meant that until all business was concluded in regards to our trade with the PDAs and the generators, we were basically stuck here. Well, shit. As for the other, do you know what this place is? You said something about trouble. How much danger are we in, really? More than enough. I'm afraid this whole place will be gone soon, and we better not be here when it happens. Wait, what? Excuse me? What are you talking about? I hoped you'd see it too, but then it took me a while to understand, and I had a head start on you. In any case, while he was speaking, my gaze wandered and fixed on some movement nearby. It was hard to make out anything, but I imagined it might have just been wind blowing through the nearby shrubbery. Except for the fact that there was no wind. Reza? This might take a while to explain, but we've got the whole night. Reza, look. He turned around to face whatever I was seeing. He squinted hard before he called out.
You! How dare you even follow me here!
The disturbance came closer until it became clear that it was Maverick, who had hidden nearby to listen in on our conversation.
I knew you were up to no good.
What were you talking about? What are you planning here? Some kind of attack? Wait a minute, there's no reason for it. Don't try to deny it. I heard you both talking about it in the cafe, and I saw the letter. You think I couldn't smell the lemon on it? Pathetic. You'll have to come with me to the police station now, both of you. Come on, I think you're overreacting. Oh.
Are you fucking stupid? Reza, what are you doing? You moron!
Oh, this guy's fucking stupid. So, now we have a shot dragon. No, just stay here. Suddenly, the dragon whipped around, hitting me in the guts with its thick tail. I was lifted off the ground briefly before I felt the impact of my body hitting the ground hard enough that my vision blurred almost immediately. A deafening roar battered my ears. Was this a cry for help? I could barely move, but I found it was better not to try. Reza is the biggest idiot in this game? Hell yeah, he's just like, yeah, let me just fucking shoot you real quick. You fucking idiot. Dude, you are literally looking at a motherfucking dragon. That's about yay big. And has muscles the size of bowling balls. You fucking stupid. As not to startle the wounded dragon more than he already was. It certainly would have ended badly for me if he tried anything. I heard him take a few unsure steps before he lay down on the ground, panting.
I'm still watching you, you know, and you better not move, for your own good. If I have to get up again and come after you in this condition, I can promise you it won't be nice.
It took a few minutes of listening to his labored breathing before someone arrived. It was two dragons. The first I recognized as Sebastian, the other one I didn't know. I heard Sebastian and Maverick exchanging a few words when the stocky fellow approached me.
Oh boy. He does not look happy!
Oh shit. Hey kid, you alright?
I think I'm alright.
I'm Bryce, the chief police in this town. Can you tell me what happened?
Well, Maverick followed us here.
Is that so? His face was stern and seemingly lost in thought as I overheard Sebastian's conversation.
Yeah, but you're the flyer on duty. We probably won't find him now. Not in the darkness, at any rate.
Well, that's just brilliant.
What do you think, Chief?
Metalcore, can you walk?
Yeah, I think so.
Alright, Sebastian, take Metalcore to the apartment. Get us some help for Maverick, and then we'll look for Reza.
Right on. Come on, Metalcore, I'll help you up.
What a stupid cunt! You are fucking... You know that could ruin everything? Just like, yeah, let me just shoot this guy. For no good reason. I mean, you fucking impulsive fuck! You fuck! Holy shit!
I'm sorry, I just get mad when people do stupid things. Especially people like this. Cocky bastard.
I was still shaken up by the events I just witnessed when I arrived at my apartment. Not knowing anything better to do, I soon fell into a deep slumber.
It's like I said, it's so fucking stupid. You could have literally created a war between us. Fucking idiot.
The next day, I awoke with many questions lingering in my head. I considered calling someone from the police department to ask about Reza and Maverick. But in the end, I decided against doing so, as I was sure they would contact me if they had anything to tell me.
Hashtag trigger. Yeah, dude. Stupidity triggers me, okay? I knew it was no use worrying about it for now, so I settled for starting another book. It didn't take very long, though, before the doorbell rang. Did Bryce, the chief of police, take it upon himself to escort me today? Oh, it's you again. Are you surprised? No, but I guess it'll mean bad news. Afraid so. How are you holding up? Better than yesterday, that's for sure. Let's go for a walk then, shall we? Sure. This time, I was taking along a different route than yesterday. And I was quite sure there was more to this than just taking a walk. I'll just go ahead and guess you didn't find Reza. Yeah, we hoped he would have come back on his own by now. Do you have any idea where he might be? Maybe he mentioned some sort of place in particular that holds some meaning to him? No, not really. We didn't get a chance to talk much at all yesterday before. And there's that too. I have no idea why Reza would have done anything like that. I had the impression they weren't very fond of each other, but this? How is he, by the way? Oh, Maverick's doing fine, but there's plenty of blame to go around. You're right, they didn't particularly like each other. In his statement, Maverick said he says he suspected Reza of planning some sort of attack. Do you know anything about that? No, he only told me that something was going to happen, not that he was planning anything. At least that's the impression I got. He's suspecting you too, by the way, that you both planned this all from the beginning. No, that wouldn't make sense. Actually, none of this is making any sense. Why would we go through all these lengths of our agreement only to jeopardize it by doing something like this? You even already have our PDAs and we don't have much to show for it yet. If we had any nefarious plans, this wouldn't have been a very good idea. Oh, you have a good point. I believe you. But from our side, we only have Maverick's word on the whole matter. After all, he was the only one that spent most time with Reza since he arrived here. But even then, he didn't really have any reason to follow you yesterday, and his behavior was completely out of line. I'm just glad you came out fine. If he wasn't on mandatory sick leave, he would be suspended right now. We'll have to wait until this whole thing is over before we decide what to do with him. I can assure you this won't be taken lightly. Oh, I hope so. I personally guarantee it. We still got quite a lot on our hands now, though. We have a wounded dragon and a missing human. This could lead to a diplomatic crisis. Maybe Reza will still show up soon and we can get all of this behind us. I hope so, too. I really wouldn't want to jeopardize everything over this unfortunate incident. Yeah. How about we just keep this quiet? How about we both just keep quiet about this whole thing for now? After all, I don't think any of us wants our people panicking about this already, right? I merely nodded in agreement. Eventually, we arrived at the police station, where the chief took my formal statement in regards to yesterday's events. He asked me about Reza and Maverick too, not that I knew much anything of that preceded yesterday's events, or the mysterious catastrophe Reza had mentioned. Afterwards, he thanked me and left to file my statement while I sat by his table, waiting and listening to the going-ons of this small provincial town police department. When he returned, he was approached by someone who seemed to have urgent news. A lot of talking between the two ensued that I couldn't make out from my position. This went on for a bit until Bryce returned to me. Oh boy. Afraid I have more bad news for you. Reza has now officially become a murder suspect. Murder? We're headed to the crime scene and hoped you'd come with us. Me? A crime scene? Well, I don't really know much about forensics. It's just that you're the only link to Reza we have, considering what he said would happen to us. It is in all our interest that we find him as soon as possible, and if he has anything to do with it, you might be able to help us find him. Your cooperation would certainly be appreciated. And it would be a nice gesture to show us that you're trustworthy in the eyes of those who might think otherwise after what happened yesterday. Will you help us? Oh, hells yeah! I suppose I don't really have much choice here, but you're right. We've got to find Raisin. If that's what it takes, then I'll do it. Very well. Let us go then. On our way to the crime scene, he tried to prepare me for what will come. I had studied biology, so I was familiar with the sight of dead animals. Asking myself how similar those would be, I wondered if my reaction would be any different if it wasn't a dragon, but a human corpse I'd be seeing. Who the fuck knows? I mean, I've seen plenty of pictures and videos of dead people, but never really seen one in person. When we arrived, we were met by Sebastian, who gave us an overview of the whole situation. This morning, the victim was found by a delivery flyer for a restaurant. Blood loss from multiple wounds are the likely cause of death. Forensics was already here, so feel free to poke around. A few paces in front of us, there the unfortunate victim was, covered by a sheet that concealed the body, but not the large red stain beneath. We approached while Sebastian went off to deter any curious onlookers. I know it won't be pretty, and I'm sorry for putting you through this, but you know what's at stake here. Just remember what I told you, and you should be fine. Alright. You ready? I guess so. Slash wounds. I mean, if Razor were to kill someone, I would say he would do it by gunshot, so... What do you think? Well, he's definitely dead. Poke, poke. Damn it, Nightsky. Yeah, R.I.P. Let's just say this will be your test, and tell me what you can deduce from what you see. Give it your best shot. Are we doing the Phoenix Wright thing here? Seriously? Two wings, two legs, just like the waitress in the cafe. About as big as a human lengthwise, if not slightly taller. The wingspan would certainly look impressive at that size. Yeah, multiple slash marks. The wounds are kind of hard to miss. True, but what are they telling you? Well, they were inflicted with a sharp implement. They're clean cuts, like from a knife or other sharp instrument. That is true, but why does this matter? Well... I mean, do dragons use knives? I don't know. Do they? Well, it couldn't have been Reza. Reza had a gun yesterday. Why would he use a knife now? Right, that weapon he was using on Maverick is called a gun, right? Yeah. What strange contraptions. Well, he could have had a reason to use a knife over his gun if it was him. Can you think of any? Well, he could have lost his gun? Well, he didn't want to make any noise. After all, he ran away from Maverick trying to hide from the police. Something as loud as a gunshot would have easily given away his position and alerted the others in the area. Right, that could be a good reason. By the way, which wound do you think was the lethal one? Well, I mean, these all don't really have any, you know, sort of blood behind them, so... I mean... Looking at just how much blood is flowing from the neck, it would be the one on his neck because he wouldn't be able to breathe either and would probably end up choking on his own blood. Which is a really nasty way to die. Drowning in your own blood. I think it was the one on his neck. That's right. If all the blood from it wasn't a giveaway, this is a stab wound, characterized by a rather small footprint. You can tell it was also the deepest one. And from the location, it's pretty obvious this must have done tremendous damage. What else do you see? Well, there's a lot of blood. The blood splatter suggests that... he had AIDS! I mean, when blood dries up, it becomes a more darker red. Hang on, I need to look up something real quick. Because if what I think is correct, hemophilia And impairs the body's ability to make blood clots, a process needed. I mean, that could be the case. Well, I'm just gonna tell him what I know for sure. I know that he died right here because there's no sign of any drag marks, no sort of splatters around it. So this is where the guy must have died. He died here, else there would have been a trail that we could follow. The splatters also suggest this is where they fought. That's true. Unfortunately, it doesn't help with determining who the perpetrator is. Objection! Excuse me? Sorry, I just always wanted to say that. You fucking nerd! I knew you were gonna do that, you bitch! I knew they were gonna make this reference the moment they went for the investigation thing. Go on, please. What about the blood on his muzzle? You tell me. The blood on his muzzle suggests that... Oh, he fought back. It might be the perpetrator's blood. Yes, that is true. I expect forensics already took a sample of it, so it might actually help us determine who the perpetrator is. And I mean, biting a human... I mean, we are pretty fragile fucks, you know? That would... You know, especially knowing how big and, well, I assume strong dragons are compared to us, I honestly have... I'm highly doubting the fact that this guy would have even, you know, be able to make it out in one piece, let alone win a fight. I think that's about everything. Investigation over. I love that, dude. You know what, kid? I'm impressed. Maybe we should have you around more often. You did well on the first investigation. Sweet! Investigator 1. Ya boy. Hey, Chief, do you still need the witness here for anything? Sebastian approached with the dragon who had discovered the body earlier. I recognized her as Adine, the waitress from the cafe. She seemed distraught, which, given the situation, wasn't very surprising. I don't think so. Take her to the department, get her statement written up, and that should be it. Sure thing. Right, miss, we're going to have to take you to the department. Of course. When she spotted me, however, her composure brightened visibly. Oh, it's the human! I have a name, you know. Actually, I don't. You never told me it. It's Metalcore. What are you even doing here? Do you work for our police now? No, it's just a hobby. Oh, you. By the way, I didn't know you also did deliveries. I do a little bit of everything, really. That's nice. I liked my, fish yesterday. You don't have to hide it. I know it's quite an acquired taste. To be fair, I wouldn't have recommended it to someone new like you, but you could always try something different. Here's our number if you don't want us to come in, and we'll deliver anything we have to you. Thanks. Sorry, I guess we should get going. Bye. What do we do now? I suppose we'll head off too, unless... How could anyone tell Adine to go away? I mean, I'm gonna go through every dialogue option in the end, so we'll find out. What is it? We got a violent homicide, and of course nobody from the department tells me. I have to find out from a neighbor who wanted to ask me about it. Good things rumors travel fast, eh? Of course nobody told you. You're on sick leave. Mandatory sick leave, I might add. I'm not here in any official capacity, you see. I'm in merely enjoying a curative walk in the fresh air and happened to come across you by accident. What do you want? I don't want anything. I just find it interesting that no one tells me about this. But the prime suspect's buddy can mess with the investigation. I see how it is. What a dick, dude. You're as bullheaded as the other guy. Fucking idiot. You're as much an idiot as Reza. You two have more in common than you might think. I know what you're thinking, but don't jump to conclusions here. I don't need to jump to conclusions. I think the dead body we found says it all. You really have an attitude problem. You know, if you weren't on sick leave, you'd be suspended right now for attacking Metalcore yesterday. Do you even have any idea what kind of repercussions this could have on us all? Yeah, like I said, it's fucking stupid! You idiot! Me attack Metalcore? As far as I can see, I'm the only one who's injured here. Besides, I'm so sorry for apparently being the only one who's doing his damn job. Right, let's all just sit idly by while the suspect's on the loose and planning his next move. Oh, you know, whatever it was Reza was talking about, he was going to tell me just before you showed up yesterday. I don't need to hear you, of all people, belittling me about this. What's your problem? If anything, I want to find him just as much as you do. Don't compare yourself to me. Your words mean nothing. Enough. You shouldn't even be here. So you better go now and get some rest before I have to take disciplinary action. Yeah, this fucker will give you good spanking. This fucker is bigger than you, bro. I just got horns on his head, so he'll just, you know, put those up your asshole. Fine, but when we find him, you'll see I was right. If I have to prove it myself, so be it. What a dick. Can he even just do his own investigation like that? Well, as long as he doesn't interfere with us, we can't really stop him from doing things in his own free time. I see. I suspect he won't adhere to the standards of performing an unbiased investigation, though. He has already made up his mind. It's clear to me that he won't be looking for facts, just for evidence to support his own view in order to prove it to us or himself. Who knows? He's always been like that. Always something to prove. We'll have to be careful. He'll be looking for Reza soon enough. What a nice thought. Well, let's hope we find him before he does. Hey, yeah. Don't worry, Reza will turn up eventually. I surely hope so. All things considered, I had to admit that it remained a possibility that Maverick was right. But could the Reza I know really be a murderer? You know what? If you think of something that might help with the investigation, or if you need anything else, just call me. I will. Well, I think we're done here. Let's go. Bryce led me back to the apartment. I guess there wasn't really much for me to do in the meantime, as I was spared the more arduous parts of the investigation. Maybe I should have been glad about this, though I now had an afternoon to fill. What should I do? Let's order us some lunch. I'm gonna be hungry. I remembered that Adina told me that the cafe did deliveries as well, and not having anything else better to do, I figured I should try it out. I made my order with a quick phone call, and it wasn't long before the doorbell rang. We're gonna go after Adina, boys. We're gonna do it. Or Adine. Adina, Adine. Oh, here we go. Yeah, we're going after Adine. 100%. Ding dong. Well, that was quick. It just so happened that Adine herself stood in the doorway, dripping wet and with damn containers in her grip. Oh boy, it's raining. Shit! Oh, it's you again. Likewise. Shouldn't come as a surprise knowing you knew I'd deliver it for the cafe. Here's your order. Sorry it got a little wet, but it should still be okay. You're soaked. Why don't you come in? Yeah, come in here. Get in. Thanks. I was just about to ask if I could stay for a little while. That was actually my last delivery for the day, and I live on the other side of town. Yeah, you don't want to go out in the rain. You'll get sick. That's a no bueno. Of course, I couldn't let you fly back when it's this ugly outside. Oh, you're such a gentleman. Feel right at home. I better eat this before it gets cold. I sat down at the table and started eating my food, while the dean decided to take a seat opposite of myself. You like it? Yeah, I ordered something I knew I'd actually like this time. I didn't want to make the same mistake I did earlier today. You have something similar where you come from? We do. As a matter of fact, it's almost scary how close it is to what we have back home. Really? Maybe we all just share a similar taste. I don't know.
That music? Yeah, it's chill. Maybe there's more to it than that.
What do you mean?
Well, don't you trace your origins back to humans in some way? I know what kind of reputation we have in your culture.
That is true. Let me ask you this. Where do you think the portal you found came from? Who built it?
Humans did it, of course.
Exactly. If you believe humans have something to do with an artifact created who knows how many years ago, it wouldn't be a stretch to think that they could have also influenced you in other ways.
Even something as simple as this dish? I like that idea.
So, what do you do when you aren't working in the restaurant? You have a family?
Well, most of the time I take care of my kids. Oh boy. Oh nice, how many children do you have?
25?
They aren't really my children per se, I just take care of them.
You're more of a foster parent then.
Not quite, these are orphan children I'm talking about. I just volunteered to spend some time with them, so I'm really more of a babysitter and teacher all in one. I can't really take them in and care for them 24/7 like a proper parent would. I would love to, but I'd be working far too much to be a single parent. With the amount of time I spend at the restaurant, I don't think the kids would be any better off, so I just help out whenever I can.
That's very nice of you.
Thanks. These kids already didn't get a very good hand in life. I just thought, if I can make even a small difference for them, then it'd be worth it.
I see. How about hobbies? You have any?
Can I ask a question for a change?
No!
Well, can you?
You're silly. I like that.
Yeah, boy.
We're doing it.
Well, I don't really know much about you. Actually, I'm not sure if there is anyone here who does.
Well, what would you like to know?
What were you doing before you came here?
Avoid the question by making a bad pun.
Nothing special, really. I mean, I have my degrees, but this is the first time I did something that was actually related to them. The work I did previously was just to keep afloat.
I know what you mean.
I suppose it's my turn again, so tell me about your hobbies.
The one I enjoy most is probably flying.
Just flying?
Well, not just flying.
I do aerobatics, or stunt flying. I've been doing that on and off for a couple of years now.
So you must be the most overqualified delivery flyer in history then.
Actually, that might not be so far from the truth. I'm actually hoping to be part of a competition in some time.
Awesome, where can I watch?
I suppose that depends on whether you will still be here when it takes place. It's part of a festival we hold in this town every year.
Okay, since it's my turn again, well, this might be an unusual question, so when they said it was a human that would be coming here, I kind of expected something a little different.
Well, what did you expect?
I'm not sure exactly, but they do say it was humans that made us who we are today. You don't seem so different from us, though.
I mean, yeah, you do look different from us, but you're really not anything like some of the things that have been said about your kind.
Well, I could say the same thing about you.
Really?
Yeah, we have plenty of myths about dragons.
Like what?
They are often cited as a symbol of power and strength, but also one of wisdom, possessing an intellect that has no equal. They are noble creatures, and their depictions enjoy an almost universal appeal.
I mean, I'm not gonna do the fucking, you know, they fucking eat people, you know, that'd be stupid.
I could get used to that. That would be even nicer if it were all true.
To be honest, I don't know if it's such a good idea to be generalizing like that, even if it's good things you're saying about us. We're all different, you know, and not all of us are nice.
I see. But then, we have said many good things about your kind, too.
Well, no matter what you might think about humans, I can assure you that I am in no way special or supernatural.
I have to disagree with that.
Why?
You say you are not special, but the fact that you're here with us right now is quite special to me and many others. Just try to see it the other way around.
You know, you actually have a good point.
What were you thinking when you first heard about us?
I wasn't sure what to think about it. That is, until I got here and was standing in front of one of you. And after that, I was just rendered speechless.
Told you so. It was special for you too. And it's not just the discovery of you dragons. We found a portal to an entirely different world. We still haven't figured that one out. Neither have we. I'm sure we'll find out soon enough. By the way, interesting selection of books you have there. Draconic Desire, Ixamon Sphere. Are these yours? No, they were already here when I moved in. Have you read any of them? I did read Sheridan and the Scepter of Sovereignty. Yeah, like I said, Indiana fucking Jones. How did you like it? I loved it. I see. Oh, you've got Price and Prayer. You should totally read that one. You think so? What's that? It's not just an interesting story. It's based on true events. The author is so right when he says there's a lot we can learn from what happened back then. I'll check it out when I have the time. Let me know when you do. I'd be interested in hearing what you have to say about it. Alright, since you asked about my family earlier, I'm going to do the same thing. Is there a Mr. or Mrs. Metalcore back home waiting for you? No. No, can't say there is. I find it interesting how they say Mr. or Mrs. So, homosexuality is both a thing and seems to be accepted. How about a potential Mr. or Mrs. Metalcore then? Are you looking to date anyone? Well, yes. Oh, it's a shame you can't be with them now then. Or are you talking about someone you met here? Maybe. Oh my. Would it happen to be someone I know? Yes. Well, who is it? I'm not sure how many questions that was, but I'm sure it's not your turn anymore. Are we even still playing this game? Well, you started it. Just having fun, you know. You and me both. You know, why don't we make this a little more interesting while we're at it? Oh, are we gonna play strip poker? It's not really fair. She's only wearing her goggles. What do you suggest? Truth or dare? Oh, boy. Oh, I see. We continue asking questions, but if one of us doesn't want to answer the question, we have to do something the other person tells us to. I don't even know what kind of dare I would make you do. It could be something that would make me uncomfortable, or something you'd like to see me do. Anything? Well, keep in mind that revenge might be coming quicker than you think, so don't ask someone to do anything you wouldn't want yourself. Got it, so who's first? Well, you asked the last few questions, so it's only fair if I start. Oh boy, this can become really interesting really quickly. Alright. I'm gonna go for this one first, obviously. So, like, which is the most ticklish? Probably my sides. Good to know. You wouldn't misuse that knowledge, would you? Oh, lady, you have no idea. You have no idea. Oh, what will I do with this knowledge? Of course not. Wink, wink. Since it's my turn now, what is your greatest wish? Be the very best like no one ever was. They had to. That seems to be a very personal wish, Metalcore. Okay, my turn. Invisible, huh? That's a hard one. I mean, no one would see my flying then, and I do want people to see that. Well, but this question is more about what you would do if you had the opportunity to do something without getting caught. Like something mischievous or criminal. Ooh, I know what I would do. I'd check out the building they found along with the portal. What building? Didn't you hear about that? They found a whole building along with the portal. It's actually underground, and they have it heavily guarded while a team of archaeologists work on it. I think it might contain many secrets and answers about the portal and where it came from. Interesting. I think I'd like to check that out as well. If you knew the world was about to end, what would you do? Well, probably enjoy life to the fullest. Going out with a bang, huh? I mean, it depends on what you mean with bang. Oh, I'm so going for this one. If I asked you to kiss me, what you doing? Is that your question or is that already a dare? A question. Just couldn't think of anything better. Oh, you fucking know it. Well, then my answer would be no. I just don't kiss anyone, you know. However, if it was a dare, my answer might be different. Alright, so from those who have made her so far, who's the one you fancy the most? I think I'll take a dare for this one. Oh, finally! Oh shit! Oh shit! What am I going to have you do? Whatever you like. No, I honestly have no idea. Well, take your time. Alright, let me think for a minute. Oh boy, this should be interesting. Oh, looks like it's getting late. Wait, what time is it? Whoops, seems like I've been here longer than I thought. I probably should be going now. Seems like the rain has stopped too. Yeah, that's great. Anyways, if you want to invite me over again, why don't I give you my personal number and we can just skip the part where you order food to make me come by. But I like the food. Or maybe I'll get your number instead. Since you ordered from us, I already have it anyway. I'm not sure what to say to that. Take it as a compliment. Bye. Damn it. I know that's coming back to bite me in the ass. That's so coming back. She was gone as quickly as she had appeared, but given her enthusiasm, I doubted that was the last time I would hear from her. Yep. Yep. More free time, huh? Let's see what Remy's up to. Hello? He told me to meet him in the lobby, but nobody's here. Maybe I should look for him. Can't be too far after all. It was quite a spacious building, lined with many bookcases on multiple floors. From the looks of it, it seemed to be as much of an archive as it was a library. With immaculate order permeating the chamber, it was the kind of place I could see myself getting lost in for an afternoon or two, thumbing through all the interesting books it could offer me. I was looking around in wonder when suddenly a voice penetrated the silence. I think you impressed her. Cough, press escape, and check status. Oh, you can actually check the status of people? Oh, she's impressed! Sweet! We're doing it, boys! Whoop whoop! Remy! I couldn't see who the voice belonged to, but it came from the more private area in the back. It was followed by footsteps that approached it. Oh, you're still here? Of course I am still here. I have business to attend to. Certainly, I just assumed you'd be done by now, Emira. Guess your assumption was wrong then. Be a good boy and bring me some coffee, will you? Oh, one of these. Okay. Of course, Emira. I heard more movement, though I still couldn't see any of the two who spoke behind all the bookcases. I assumed the area was off limits to a visitor like myself and decided to wait. Here you go. Now let me read in peace, you silly boy. Oh. Of course. I heard him walk towards my direction until he emerged from behind a bookcase and spotted me. Oh, hello, Metalcore. I didn't expect you so soon. Better be safe than sorry. Well, I'm glad to see you again, at any rate. Who was that back there? I guess you heard that, didn't you? That was my superior. She's the Minister of Culture and Arts, which means I'm technically in an employment. Though, generally speaking, I work for the Council at large, just not her. So, this is where you work, huh? Most of the time, yes. That makes you a librarian, I suppose. Well, there's a little more to it. I'm not just in charge of the books. I'm a scholar and study them too. Sweet. This guy's clever. For example, if the council requests knowledge on certain topics, like facts, statistics, or any other information of interest, it is my part
or if it's part of my job to research it and present it to them in an appropriate manner. I love knowledge of gaming. It's a button. So you're basically an expert on everything? Not just an expert at finding information. Anyways, was there a particular reason why you wanted to meet me?
You're just too damn cute, that's why.
Okay, I am actually gonna go refill because my cup is empty. I'm not gonna fucking... It is empty, so I'm gonna go refill real quick. I will be right back.
Why, hello again, you dragon fuckers. Okay, myths about humans.
Oh, right, I still have work to do, but I could show you something afterwards. Either way, now that you're here, you could help me with something. I've got some books that need to be sorted over. Oh, you're just gonna shove your responsibilities onto me? You dick? You fucking asshole, already abusing me. You cocksucker. I respectfully decline your request for help. Alright, how the fuck do we fit that in? Oh no, the arrangement you see in this library is based on a sophisticated system that sorts everything in a very intuitive manner based on a number of criteria. Genre, author, complexity, and age. Oh fuck, this is already giving me a headache. As you can probably tell, we have a lot of specimens, so just sorting them by alphabet would be far from sufficient. That does sound very intuitive.
It is. Oh, he looks so satisfied about it. It's like, oh, I just love books! Books!
You're such an egghead, Remy. Basically, these 8 books you see over there were all part of a section that was moved, so now they have to be sorted in their new area. The problem is their labels are so old that they started to fade away, which makes sorting them a little harder. They will get new labels soon, but until then, we will just have to make do with what we have here. All of them are by Hazik Akil, a writer on the subject of history, and a very prolific one, I might add. You will find the shelf they belong to over there. Now it's just a matter of placing them in the right order from oldest to newest. I have written down everything still legible from the old labels here. For someone like you, putting them in order shouldn't be a problem. In any case, I'll be working on something else in the meantime, so let me know once you're done.
Woo!
Hints. The third war is directly preceded by the spark. The first war is directly preceded by the inception. The invention is not the third, seventh, or last book. The second war is the fourth book. There is only one book before the first war. So, inception is first. Because there's only one book before it. I need a notepad for this. Do I have any paper here? I should have some notes left.
I don't actually, damn it! Give me something to write on. Whoops. Well, piece of cardboard, that'll do, I guess. The Enlightenment comes at some point after the Third War. Okay, let's take a look at the hints real quick. Yes, I know this. Okay, so we have a bunch of books. I don't know how many. I'm just gonna number 1, 2, 3. If you don't feel like figuring it out, I have the answer on hand. No, 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 no. No, you don't do that. You don't do that. I want to figure this one out. Damn it. 4, 5, 6. I don't know how many there are. I'll just say there's 7. So the first one is the first is... Let me see. The first one is Inception. So first is the Inception. So the first war must be second. The first war. So the second war is the fourth book. The second war is the fourth book. So that goes to number 4. The second war. Okay, so we have the Inception. It will take some time for him. Fuck you, dude. See, so the Inception comes first. Then we have the First War. The Invention is not the third, seventh, or last book. Okay, so let me see. There were 10 books, right? So I have 10 books. So the Enlightenment comes at some point after the Third War, and the Third War is directly preceded by the Spark. Let me see. The Invention cannot be the third, seventh, or last book. So, it's not the third one. I'm thinking 5 and 6 might be the third war and the spark. 8 books. Okay, 8 books. Okay, so there's 8 books. I'm thinking that the spark is number 5. Let me see. The spark can be number 5. Then number 6 is... No, wait. That can't be true. Let me see. No, I think the Invention is book number 5. I believe. It almost has to be number 5. Because it cannot be the 3rd, 7th, or 8th. The Tribe is the book not mentioned in the hints. Let me see. So I think the 3rd War is the last book. 3rd War has to be the last book. I believe. No, wait, it can't, because the Enlightenment comes some point after the Third War. Okay. So that means... No, but that's not possible. So the invention must be book number 5. Because the third book... Let me see, 5 has to be the invention then. Let me see, 6 then has to be the spark. 7 is the third war. Then the enlightenment, which would be the last one. Then the tribe would be the third one. Okay, let me see. So, 6 would be the spark. 7 would be the third war. Number 8 would be the enlightenment. And then the third one should be the tribe. Let me see. So the first war is preceded by the inception. The invention is the 5th book. So it's not the 3rd, 7th, or last. Second war is on number 4. There's only one book before the first war, which is the inception. Which is correct. And the enlightenment comes at some point after the third war, which it directly does. So this is what I have right now. Hang on, let me... This should be correct. If what I think is correct. Okay, so the first is... The inception. The second book is the first war. The third book is the tribe. The fourth book is the second war. The fifth book is the invention. Number 6 is the spark. 7 is the third war. And the 8th is the enlightenment. I think that's all of it. Oh, you're done? Let's take a look then. I hope I got it right. Seems you got it all right. Well done, Metalcore. Yes! Woo! I did it. Yeah, boy. Haha. I am super clever. See, that's why you should keep like a sketch pad or like something to write on around, because it can really help thinking. You brought Remy's books in the correct order. I am a librarian. Yeah, boy. That wasn't too hard. In any case, there's a box here that belongs in storage. You can put that away. I'll finish the last bit of sorting, and then we'll be done for the day. Shit, do I have to? Sure thing, bro. Great, see you in a bit then. I mean, I didn't even know where storage is. And books are heavy. I lifted the box and carried it towards its shelf. Holy shit, my entire desk is shook. But as I was just about to reach it, I tripped suddenly, sending me to the ground as the contents of the box spilled across the floor. God damn it. Ouch! Those don't sound like books. I scrambled to gather the various items as the voice of the dragon called out to me. Is everything alright? Before I could answer, Remy came around the corner, his face bearing a look of disapproval. He stooped over and helped me pick up the spilled objects. Yeah, I'm fine. I was mainly asking about the priceless artifacts you just dropped. You fucking cocksucker. Well, sorry. Well, it doesn't look like anything is broken. It could have ended up much worse. What is all this stuff anyway? In preparation for arrival, I wanted to study what knowledge we had on humans. And, well, what did you learn? Not much. The human is a creature shrouded in mystery and legend, yet one we apparently share some history with. Sure, dragon, tell me I'm the mythological creature. As the story goes, we dragons were once a primitive and savage civilization, living in caves and whatnot. We fought other creatures and among each other for resources and territory. One day, however, a human arrived who performed many miracles and gave us the gifts of electricity and reason. We refer to this event as our awakening. What happened to them, and who were they anyway? They say it was a divine creature, a supernatural being that saved our species by making peace between our clans and uniting us, as our numbers were dwindling from our pointless conflicts. And when the deed was done, they ascended to the heavens from where they came, or turned into a dragon and lived among us, ruling with kindness and wisdom until their eventual passing, depending on who you ask. And what do you make of this story? As unlikely as it sounds, there is evidence for a sudden, unprecedented technological advancement in our timeline. We have artifacts from that time that couldn't have been built with the knowledge back then. I'm starting to think you already have a theory. Indeed, I take it you are familiar with the ways the portals through which you traveled here actually work? Well, not very. It's simple, really. There are spontaneous wormholes that pop into existence now and then, but their highly unstable nature means that they instantly collapse on themselves. The machinery of the portal merely stabilizes the wormhole so that we may utilize it. We are actually just taking advantage of a naturally occurring phenomenon. Fascinating. Long story short, my theory is that this legendary person stumbled upon one of these natural wormholes in the split second it existed, bringing them into our world. Being thrust into an unfamiliar world with no means to return to their own, talk about being at the wrong place at the wrong time. Or just the right one, if you ask me. If it wasn't for them, we wouldn't be here today. Oh, what I would give to get know more about them. How do you know so much about the portal anyway? Oh, we found it a while ago, so we had time to study it. Not me personally, mind you, but I followed its developments with great interest. Well, what else have you discovered about it? Oh, not much, I'm afraid. We didn't want to take the risk of permanent damage, and we won't do anything rash until we completely understand the technology and can replicate it for ourselves. So far, the only thing it has done for us was locating your portal and connecting us to it. From the interface, it appears to have more functions, but we haven't been able to get any of them to work. We were not even sure what it was capable of when we initially turned it on. Only after some time of being active did it actually find your portal, and only then were we able to make the connection. Making that discovery must have been very exciting, especially when you made contact with us and started exchanging letters with us. Oh, you have no idea. Especially when Reza arrived and he turned out to be a human of all things. Some people still worship them, you know? Well, you've mentioned that before. How does that work? Do you have some kind of organized religion based around it? Well, not exactly. It's more like an adoration on a personal level. I'd count myself among them if it wasn't for the fact that I consider myself to have a much more reasonable approach to it than others. For example, there are those that believe there is much more to your sudden appearance than there really is. I think they expect some sort of miracle from you, similar to what was ascribed to humans in the past. Well, I could tell you that there is nothing supernatural about me. That's what I expected. Either way, as a scholar, I'm looking forward to seeing everything your PDAs have to offer. I could show you sometime. I see. Well, don't worry about explaining them to me. I'm sure you have much more important things to do while you are here. It's just a question of time until one of them ends up with me anyway. Actually, the PDAs are one of the reasons I volunteered to come here. What do you mean? I know them pretty well, enough to explain how they work at least. Of course, that is far from the only reason. I just thought I'd be the kind of person who would meet all of the requirements, and it turned out I was. I see. It was nice of you to volunteer when you must have known there would be considerable risks coming here. Well, you volunteered as well when you came to meet me, didn't you? I wouldn't think this kind of thing would fall under your jurisdiction regularly. That is true, but by this point my interest in these things shouldn't surprise you. Oh, you're so gay, Remy! I see that blush! I was more than I surprised. Excuse me. I was more surprised that I arrived under cover of darkness to meet an ambassador, though I haven't seen much of you since. Initially, they wanted to have an official reception headed by myself, but in the end, they changed their minds due to security concerns, as I told you back then. I suppose that's also why I'm being escorted by the police all the time.
Yeah, that was supposed to be my job too, until someone from the police department objected and advocated for more security. Better be safe than sorry, I suppose. Let me guess, that someone was Maverick. How'd you know that? Just a hunch. At least I still got to meet you. Were you nervous when you did? Only the brave or the foolish wouldn't be. I consider myself neither. Well, I was too. To be fair, I would have been as well if we didn't already know about humans and Reza. Reza. There was a moment of... oh no. There was a moment of silence between us, and our eyes met briefly when suddenly a loud call echoed through the building. Remy! I better go and see what that is about. Maybe it would be better if you didn't stay out in the open. At the end of the hallway, you could find my office towards the right. Wait for me there. Alright. Dang, that's a nice office. He's even got a laptop and shit. Rummage through his trash. Drink his coffee? See what his notebook has to say. Heavy paper, perfect binding. I can tell by the cover alone that this is not the cheap stuff, but the result of quality bookmaking. Alright, let's take a peek inside. Looks like uncertain notes. His handwriting's terrible. Nope, can't make it out. Well, let's take a look at his computer. I wonder if their computers are similar to ours. Let's see. At the press of a button, the screen came to life, accompanied by the whir of the machine. After a few seconds, colorful images appear on the screen. Is this a game? Are you kidding? Wait, has this fucker made a game including himself? What? Ronin? This is like Pokemon! LOL! This is kinda epic. It evokes cosmic horror! LOL! Jesus! God damn it, blue screen. What the? Hey, what are you doing? Nothing. Oh no, let me take a look. Why did you even touch the computer? I just wanted to see what was on it. Well, whatever you did, at least it seems to be okay. Oh no, my game! What's wrong? When you touched the computer, you saw a game running, right? Yeah, I played a little. I saved it specifically at that moment to play it later. Now it's all gone. No! What do you mean it's all gone? So much preparation. So many hours spent grinding. HL3.exe? Yeah, I noticed that. Just to get there. I can't do all of that again. You wouldn't understand. Sorry. To be fair, the computer is old, so it might not have been your fault. Well, at least my office is still standing. Okay, I am not that big of a klutz, okay? Speaking of which, what's with the bed? Looks like you live here. When I have to work late, it's just easier to stay here. Typical gamer dragon, LMAO. Besides, I have the whole knowledge of the library at my fingertips, and I can use the resources and equipment as I please. Like this computer. Don't you have one at home? No, we generally don't have this kind of technology in every household, though it's not exactly rare either. We just use it whenever we need it. Well, back home, we used to have computers everywhere. Most of us even carried one on our wrist wherever we went. I'm so sad I don't have like a smartwatch. Is that so? Ding.
Oh, that means the library will be closing pretty soon. If you want to do or ask anything in particular, now's the time. Are you available? Oh, whoops. Sorry. I'd like to know more about your myths. Well, there's a lot we could get into, but I'm afraid we won't have enough time now. Maybe another day. Anyways, thank you for your help. If there's any way I can repay you, you just let me know. How about you invite me to dinner sometime? How about a kiss? Are you fucking kidding me? Oh, I can't really think of anything. Well, what do humans typically do in such a situation? Oh, you know, just a favor? I'll invite them for a meal, probably. And that's what I'll do. Sounds good to me. Alright then, have a nice evening. You too. He parted amicably, or so I thought. Would I see him again? I wasn't sure, but I kept his number just in case. I don't like where that's going.
Dramatic switch tonight. Chapter 2, Duty.
Sweet. I hear fire. Oh no! Oh no. No, no, no. Don't you touch that portal. Don't you do that, you cocksucker.
Another day, another morning. I awoke from dreams filled with fire and smoke.
Okay.
The sun shining through the window gave me a comforting feeling of familiarity, despite the portal in the distance reminding me of my purpose here. I looked towards the horizon, my view undisturbed by dividing walls. The light of the morning sun was painting the sky with golden hues, a view that had become a rarity back home. It evoked a feeling of freedom and openness that was almost scary to me. While I got ready for the day, my thoughts strayed to the people I knew back home. I couldn't help but wonder how they were doing. But I had greater things to worry about at the moment, like Reza, murders, and generators. How much danger was I in, really? Ding dong. Someone's at the door. Hey, MetalCore. Need to go to the toilet so badly, but I don't want to miss anything either, so I'll wait a moment. I'll wait for a moment, that's an interesting. Hey Chief, more bad news? Not quite, until you count Razor missing as bad news, but that's kinda why I'm here. Well, what is it? Just some good old fashioned police work. And we're counting on your help. Again. Well, I'm not really in the mood to look at corpses today, sorry. Don't worry, we have something else planned. We obtained a list of places Reza visited in the days before he vanished. We'll check those out, maybe find a lead, and you might help us understand his motivations or give us some context to his actions. I can certainly try. Sure you'll do a great job. That's reassuring. Ready to go? Let's do it. Speaking of which, what's my status? He's impressed, we're good. Okay, cool. There's a couple of places we can check out. Let's see where we will go first. While Bryce focused on his list, I saw someone approach out of the corner of my eye. A closer look revealed that it was Sebastian, waving his arm in an attempt to get us our attention as he ran towards us, his face grave. There you are, Chief. I was looking for you. What are you doing here? Don't tell me there's another dead person. Sorry, Chief. There is. God damn it! Damn, guess it's gonna be one of those days. Yeah, looks that way. Someone else can take care of that today, though. We've got other plans. You'll need to sign off on a few things, at least. I know. We'll go to the crime scene, sign a few forms, and then we're out. Why do people keep dying? Stop it! When we arrived at the scene, I saw the poor victim next to one of the houses. The obligatory sheet that was draped over him provided a modicum of discretion, but nothing to hide the crime that had occurred. Alright, give me the story. It's an interesting one, that's for sure. The wounds match the one of those of the last victim, so a similar, if not identical, murder weapon is likely. The victim? Maintenance person for this area, and the electricity is out. The power goes out, means guy shows up and is killed before he can fix the problem. At least, that is my theory. So the power for the whole block is still out? That is correct. We should get that fixed as soon as possible. We don't need civilians showing up around here complaining about sitting in the dark. Good point. Bryce's snout wrinkled with distaste as he glanced over Sebastian's shoulder.
Damn, not again. What is it?
What are you doing here, Maverick?
A second victim, huh?
This is an official investigation, so you better not cross that police line.
Shunned by my own colleagues, this is ridiculous.
You know how it is, rules are rules, and without rules, murders like this one would be allowed to happen and go unpunished.
Chew. Have your fun without me then.
Yeah, fuck off. What do you think you wanted here, Chief? That one's easy, to do his own investigation, just like you said he would. I shouldn't be surprised he showed up, but I guess we're lucky we arrived before he did.
I agree. We better check out that power outage now.
Of course, I think the door to the maintenance room is right around here.
That's a long fucking way down. You got your flashlight, Seb?
Always, Chief.
You should go first then. I don't have my stuff here.
Besides, putting on that head mount is such a hassle.
I remember. You complain about that every time it comes up.
There, that should do the trick.
See, people are once again messaging me. What?
Killer?
You just stay behind me. Metalcore, alright?
Okay.
Gah, I hate stairs. Especially those made for smaller dragons like you.
Trust me, having it the other way around isn't too great either.
I dislike all kinds of stairs. Period. That's what I'm talking about.
This kind of reminds me of when we found that underground base or whatever it was. Remember, Chief?
How could I not? It wasn't that long ago.
Underground base?
Yeah, the portal wasn't the only piece of ancient technology we found. There was also this whole lab near it. Seemed to have some high-tech stuff in there. At least that place didn't have as many stairs.
Lol.
Wait, so you not only found the portal, but a whole facility along with it?
Yes, but we're not sure how much the two are actually related.
We spent all that time studying the portal and barely got anywhere with it. This stuff is just beyond what we know.
Here we are.
Am I gonna get jump scared here? Is that a thing? Please tell me it's not.
So, what exactly are we looking for? Whatever's causing the power outage. If we don't find the cause, we should at least be able to get the backup running.
Looks like the generator is gone. Well, mystery solved.
The sound of creaking metal penetrated the stillness of the room.
The fucking vents.
I looked above towards the sound of the noise as it grew louder, and in the next instant I was pushed sideways and fell to the ground, just barely avoiding the giant light fixture that fell from the ceiling and shattered into countless pieces alongside me.
Metalcore, you alright?
The next thing I saw was a hooded figure standing above me, barely visible against the darkness that permeated the room.
Motherfucker!
Wait.
That's not him.
Who the fuck are you?
Oh!
The figure crouched down next to me, its mask hovering right in front of my face. Merely a whisper reached my ears when it spoke.
Be careful, Metalcore.
Then the figure dashed towards the stairs.
Where are you going?
That's not me!
Don't move! He's going up the stairs!
I'm on it!
I didn't see that chair coming.
Can't see a damn thing in here.
Here, Chief. I hate these stupid stairs. You're blocking the way. Just go around me.
There's no room. You're as wide as the stairs are.
I can't help it. I'm fat.
Damn it. We'll never catch him now.
The fuck?
By the time we found our way back up, the mysterious figure was nowhere to be found.
Well, we've got a long search ahead of us. With a head start like that, there might be no end to it. Well, we have to take our chances as long as we still can. Except the chance is growing smaller and smaller while we wait for the team to arrive. What even happened down there? Right, Metalcore, tell us everything in as much detail as you can. Well, there wasn't much to it. I heard a noise, I looked up, the light fixture came down, then someone pushed me. You mean Reza? I'm not so sure of that. Didn't you see him? Whoever it was wearing a mask. It bloody well can't be someone else, so let's not kid ourselves here. Why would he wear the whole getup, though? Well, some sort of... well... that's a bad excuse when there are only two humans here. This whole thing doesn't make any sense. Let's take a step back and look at the bigger picture. Your earlier theory about what happened was pretty sound, Sebastian. Let's go with that, and then add a bit about the generator being stolen. So now the question is, who has a motive for stealing a generator? Well, Reza. Right, who else would need to steal a generator when those who live here could either buy or even simply request one? Not to mention, Reza was the one who arranged the diplomatic trade for the generators in the first place. Well, I can't deny the fact that your generators are pretty important to us, but resorting to murder? I don't even care from where the music is. It's chilling and very nice, and that's what counts. Yeah. Oh, why would he have stayed there? Because that wouldn't make sense. Perhaps this is a case where the criminal has returned to the crime scene. For this kind of crime, I'd say no, but who knows? Maybe our rules don't apply anymore. What do you mean? No offense, but ever since you two humans arrived, there's been a lot of strange things going on. This place used to be a quiet town. Oh, it's starting to sound like maybe this whole thing is just a huge misunderstanding. Let's put this into perspective. We found two corpses so far. Reza is the prime suspect, and all he needs is someone to talk to him? Sorry, but I'll be going with a no on that one. Maybe we should just focus on finding him and point fingers later. Pretty much. Agreed. The police team will be here any minute now. You don't have to get involved with the search, but that doesn't mean you can't help us. Well, what do you want me to do? We still have the list of places we were going to check out, remember? We can't go now. The search takes priority. Of course, we'll still check out those places after we're done here, but if you go on your own, you can speed up the process. You could even find a lead for us. Who knows? Well, sure thing. Great. Here's the list. Considering your status, you shouldn't have any trouble in these places, but if anything happens, call me and I'll check up on you later. Wait a minute, do you mean I'm going all by myself? All of us are going to be busy with the search, and we really can't afford to spare someone right now. You'll be fine. Aren't you worried that I'll do something fishy? I mean, isn't that why Reza and I were assigned police escorts in the first place? That policy was mostly Maverick's fault, and he's out of the picture. With my authority as chief, I say you can go alone. I already know where you're going, and besides, I trust you. If you were in cahoots with Reza, you would have run off with him when you had the chance. Good point. Ah, I see the team approaching. Guess you should get going. Alright, I'll see you later then. Good luck. So... it was a relief to leave the crime scene, considering all that had happened. When I reached into my pocket to take a look at the list... however, I found something unexpected. It was a small piece of paper with the word Tatsu written on it. How did it get there? Bryce has a nice smile. My earlier encounter with the masked person was the only time someone today was close enough to smuggle something into my pocket. I figured if someone like Bryce tried something like that, I definitely would have noticed. As for Tatsu, the only related thing I could think of was Tatsu Park, which I had come across when I went to the police station the other day. Even if that park was the place the mysterious paper referred to, I didn't know if it was actually a good idea to visit. The masked person may have saved me from the falling light fixture, but if it was Reza, it would mean following someone who was also the prime suspect of two murders.
I also have to consider the list of places Reza has been to. A local grocery store, the production facility we had visited, and the library were the three places closest to here. It certainly was going to be a busy day, and I knew I wouldn't have time to visit all of them. Let's go to the production facility. Let's just see what's on there. Reza was allegedly here at some point. Maybe I should ask Anna. Knock, knock! Hello? 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 Anybody here? Can I help you? I was just looking for Anna. This is her lab, right? Why don't I ever get any recognition? This is my lab as much as it is hers. Either way, Anna's not here. Would that be all? Well, since you work here, maybe you can help me instead. Oh, of course, your precious Anna isn't here, so you have to set it for me. I see how it is. That's not what I meant. Of course, let's just get this over with. Well, you can start by telling me who you are. Here's the short version. My name is Damien, I work in this facility, and I'm unfortunate enough to live the nightmare of having to deal with Anna on a daily basis. Nice to meet you. Seem like a lovely person. Nice to meet you too. And you are? You don't know who I am? Of course I know who you are, but your assumption validated the point I was going to make. You see, this whole thing about you coming here has been blown out of proportion, like it's some huge event that everyone should be celebrating. Newsflash, not everyone cares. Once both of you are gone, life will return to normal and we can all go back to what we actually should be doing. I imagine a lot of it has to do with all those human myths you have. I can only reiterate, not everyone cares. What exactly did you want again? Has Reza been here recently? I've seen him a few times. He would come by to ask about the progress of the generators. There was this one time when Anna told him she'd have news, but when he came over, she just wanted to run some tests on him. Did he go through with it? No, he wanted some compensation, I suppose. Nothing she could offer satisfied him, however, and that was that. Well, what kind of research are you doing? Right now? Guess who got tasked with running all those tests on your blood? You did? That's right. Well, she goes out and does whatever the heck she wants, I get to keep an eye on the experiment. Any interesting results? Not just yet, but soon we'll know more about your body than you do. Well, what kind of research is she doing? Cancer research? She thinks she can cure it, but she's out of her mind. Is that such a bad thing? The way she does it? Yes. She's wasting resources that could be better spent on projects with an actual chance of success. So long if you've known her. Why do you care about that? Maybe I want to find out what kind of person she is. You might have an idea. I'll put it this way. I've known her far too long. That's all. Yeah, she's like, I don't like people! You interrogated Damien. Investigator 1. Okay, let's visit the grocery store. See what's going on there. I entered the store, the sound of a bell alerting the staff to my arrival. Seeing the patrons browsing the shelves neatly stocked with wares of all kinds evoked some feelings of nostalgia and normalcy in me. Oh, this must be the store Reza has been shopping at. Who's he talking to? Hey, I think I've seen her before. I'm sorry, but this prescription has expired. Oh, she's gonna die. I can't fill it like this. You'll need to tell your parents to visit the doctor so he can write you a new one. It's like, shit! She turned around, nearly running into me, when she suddenly bolted towards the door. Hello, Metalcore. How can I help you? You know who I am? How could I not? Everyone knows about you. Anyway, how can I help you? Do you remember this guy? Of course I do. It's only been a few days since he was last here. Well, this will sound a little unusual, but can you tell me what he bought? Are you just talking about last time or every time he came here? Both, I suppose. He came here more than once? Oh, he's been visiting pretty regularly, now that I think about it.
Interesting. I can look up his purchases if you like. That would be really helpful. Shouldn't be too hard. Just give me a second. Pretty sure there should be some, you know, fucking privacy issues. Here you go. Receipts from all his purchases. Oh, that was easy. Since our government takes care of all his purchases, they're piled separately. It was simple to pull them up. Looks like he bought mostly food and snacks. Sometimes magazines. But why was he buying lemons every single time? Well, the secret letters. Can't say that I didn't notice, but I figured it was just a human thing. Strange. In any case, that was more information than I expected. You have my thanks. You're welcome. Also, who is that? You mean the girl? That's Vara. She comes here occasionally to pick up her mother's prescription. Okay. Well, I suppose that's all I can do here. The afternoon sun hung low in the sky, and I decided it was time to report my findings to the police. A brief call to the department, and I was on my way to an appointment with Sebastian. I'm not sure how my findings will help, but at least I'll have something. Look who we have here. I turn around to see Maverick. His intense gaze confirmed that there was no one else his words could have been directed at. Even with the civilians passing by in the background, I suddenly felt very alone. What do you want from me? Answers. Well, would I don't have any for you? Then you will listen. Just tell me one thing. Why? What is your goal in all of this? Why even come here? Well, you know why. This! No, that won't do. That's simply not true. You know it and I know it. I just don't get why you can't be honest with me, even when you know no one else is listening. You know I can't touch you. If I did, it would be all over for me. At least, as long as I don't have any proof. In the end, what difference does it make if I know? No one's going to believe me anyway. You wish to kill me too, like Reza? I would never do such a thing. Is that so? Tell me, why would an ambassador need such a dangerous tool in the first place? I know you claim not to have one of these things Reza injured me with, and you didn't have any when they searched you, but I guess it's way too late for safety precautions at this point. You could have hidden one anywhere. That damn hurt, you know. But even worse than that was getting thrown aside by Bryce. I trust him, but after what happened, he doesn't trust me anymore. Now there's only you. The mythical, the special, the new. How much I wish I could make him see what I see. I could have saved the world with what I did that day, and it still wouldn't matter when no one believes me, just because I don't have any proof. But I won't stop until I find some. And when I do, I'm going to be a damn hero. Okay. And with that, he was gone. On the way to the police station, Maverick's words kept finding their way back into my mind. I couldn't decide how to feel about them. I wasn't even sure if it was worth mentioning to the police, since all he did was make vague accusations. It wasn't anything substantial enough to be considered a threat. However, his actions were growing more calculated, and he seemed very sure of himself. I wondered about what this could amount to. But that wasn't the problem at hand. Now, first we gotta fight the other fucker. Hey, MetalCorp. Hey, Sebastian. Thought I'd meet you at the front desk. What are we doing in Bryce's office? He does have a nice office, doesn't he? And the chairs are comfy. Maverick is scary? Not really, he just seems like a bullheaded bully, to be quite honest. You know, a lot of muscle, no brains. Is that the only reason we're in here? The dragon gave a brief chuckle. Let's just say that any information pertaining to this case is important enough to warrant some privacy. Not going to spoil that? I see. Will Bryce be here anytime soon? I don't think so. He's still outside looking for Reza. He's not the kind of person who gives up easily. Well, sounds like him. That's Bryce for you. Once he sets his mind on something, he sees it through to the end. That's why he's our chief. He gets things done. At this rate, it doesn't look like we'll find him today. He could be anywhere, long gone, beyond our reach. What do you think? Well, I don't think he would be going anywhere because he still needs the portal. I don't think he's going anywhere. He can't flee to another place. No matter where he goes, he'd be recognized immediately. In the end, his only way is the same way out. In the end, his only way out is the same way he got in, the portal. And he can't use that without someone noticing. Very astute observation. I feel like, damn, my ending was terrible. Won't spoil anything, but nope. Oh boy, that should be fun. I wonder what will happen to our trade agreement now, considering Reza's still missing, the murders, and the stolen generator. If Reza really is the murderer, then... Don't do that. What? Worry? You don't know what's at stake here. People are dead, Metalcore. Don't you think I don't know that? Reza may be our prime suspect, but he's also a missing person. For all we know, he could be a victim. Maybe someone is making him do this. My point is, we don't know the facts yet. What we need to do is find him and find the murderer. Two separate things. Good. We'll find Reza and go from there. We'll figure it out. Thanks, bro. Anyway, you said you had some information for us, so what do you find? The receipts you got are interesting. There might be something more to them, or they could just be useless record of his eating habits. You never know what you might find out about a person, their habits, or their plans this way. I'm not sure if there's anything special about Anna wanting Reza's blood. I mean, she's a scientist, so it's natural she'd be interested in something like that. We'll have to talk to her about it, though. Maybe she has some details for us. Well done, Metalcore. That gives us some solid points on which we can continue our investigation. You did well on the second investigation. Yep, boy! I'm actually doing good for once. In any case, thank you for your help. We really do appreciate it. You're welcome. That should be all then. Since Bryce still hasn't come back, I assume the search is still going on. And I better get out there and help him. Guess it's going to be a long day. Can you find your way back to your apartment? Of course. Alright, I'll see you later. Good luck.
Good hunting.
Finally, some free time. Whatever am I going to do? Looks like there's some messages on the answering machine. Let's see. Please leave a message after the beep. Gotcha, you thought that was your answering machine, but it was me, Adeem. I know we talked about me coming over again, but I thought, why not mix it up and you come to me instead? I mean, it's not like I can use your excuse and pretend to order something from you. After all, you don't even have anything to sell or deliver. Unless... Well, I don't think you're that kind of person. Well, who knows? Maybe I am. Mm-hmm. Oh, I do hope this is the right number or someone is going to be very confused. I'm actually glad someone that makes a stream about this game. I mean, you know, Nightsky bought it for me and he was like, okay, yeah, you gotta either record or stream it. So I decided to stream it for him. And on YouTube as well. JK. Well, she did get the right number, and I'm still confused. Okay, well, we're going for a Dean. What's up, girl? This should be the right address. Knock, knock. I'm coming. If you know what I mean. Oh, it's you. I was expecting someone else. You're a little early. Yeah, I didn't know how long it would take me to get here. Better early than late, right? Oh, hello there. Oh, you are just adorable. Oh, look at you. Oh, you're cute. And who might that be? This is Emily. She's one of the kids I work with. Hello, Emily. Say hi, Emily. Hello. He dates my waifu. I just have to bring her back to the orphanage real quick. Feel free to make yourself at home in the meantime, okay? Sure. You met Emily. Look at this place. So this is where you live, Adeen. Small, but cozy. She's back already? Holy shit. Hang on. That was quick. Being able to fly does have its perks, you know. Wait, you flew her back? Well, I am a delivery flyer. She doesn't get scared or anything? Not at all. She's such a brave little girl. So, what exactly is it that you do at the orphanage? I'm a volunteer. I help them out with whatever they need, and sometimes take care of the kids. They only have so many social workers. The ratio is about one social worker for every 10 children? Are you fucking joking? Well then, so it's good for the kids to spend some time one-on-one with someone they know. I guess you could almost call it babysitting, but for the kids, we basically become foster parents. The older they get, the less likely they are to be adopted. She might be too old to be considered soon. Well, I'd adopt her if I could. I'm afraid it's just not that easy, and the actual numbers of adoptions aren't very promising either. I'm worried about what will happen to her if she doesn't find a family. We will still take care of her, of course, but it's not quite the same as having parents. I'd adopt her myself, but I don't think I could care for her properly. Not as a single parent with my packed work schedule. I still volunteer as often as I can, because if I don't, who will? Someone needs to be there for those kids. That's very nice of you. Thanks, but for me, it's not about being nice. I almost feel obligated to help, you know? Anyways, let's talk about something less depressing. Oh, like what? Let me think. Oh, I just remembered that someone died here recently. Oh, come on. That's depressing. Here in your apartment? No, not here, silly. It was close, though. Barely a block from here. Right, the murder of the maintenance guy. I remember that. Wait, it was murder? I didn't know that. I thought it was an accident or something. That's terrible. Sorry for mentioning it. Finding the first victim was already bad enough for me, and now I have to hear there was another murder in town? I wish I could get some good news for once. Don't just focus on the bad things. It's no use lamenting something you can't change. Sorry, Metalcore, I guess I should be more positive. It's just not always easy, you know? Well, maybe you'll get some good news soon. I hope so. That reminds me, I've got something I wanted to try on you. Oh boy, here we go. Try on me? It's nothing too dramatic. I read this article, this magazine the other day, and found a few interesting articles. Oh boy. Using her partial hands, she held up a magazine to show me the cover. A rather bold-looking female was presented on the front, adorned with trinkets like rings and jewels. Various headlines gave me an idea of the content within. It reminded me a lot of the typical gossip magazines back home. I'm the president and I finished the game a few hours ago. I mean, it does appear to be a rather, you know, emotional game, which I like. Lifestyle, the magazine for modern people? Well, I already hate that fucking title. Like, you have to be modern. Like, fuck off. This issue even came with a set of fortune cards. I'm sure they're qualified to determine my fate. With articles like 5 Steps to Get the Partner of Your Dreams, I'm sure they're qualified to determine my fate. Come on, it'll be fun. If you say so. What should we look at first? You decide. Alright, let's see. Here, this article talks about dreams and what they mean. Have you had any strange or recurring dreams lately? Well, I've been dreaming of fire. Interesting. Apparently, it's a rather common symbol that can mean a variety of things. Another thing to consider is the significance of the symbol to the dreamer. So what does fire mean to you? Fire can be destructive, but also wild and passionate. It can represent an issue or a problem you can no longer ignore, similar to an actual fire breaking out. It also mentions prophetic dreams, but let's hope that yours don't fall into that category. I mean, I am emotional. I experience emotional roller coaster, which occur once every few years. I mean, yeah, I don't really have those as This is an emotional waterfall. Yeah, pretty much. I mean, I don't know yet, but I can imagine it being so. Hang on, let me just... scratch my ears. I doubt they do. Phew. What about your dreams? It kind of feels like they're different every night. Most of them are nonsense, but sometimes I dream of people I used to know. What do you make of all this? I don't know. Even the article concludes that scientists haven't figured out exactly why we dream. It's a big mystery. Alright, let's move on. Oh, I thought you meant moving on from the magazine. Don't be such a sourpuss. There's some interesting stuff in here. I'll reserve judgment on that. That's probably for the best. Well, what's next? A personality test. Didn't you always want to know what kind of relationship would suit you? Sure, why not? Let's find out. Oh boy. Okay, first question. In a relationship, what role do you take? I'm normally emotionally stable, but this game caught me off guard. Totally. Yeah, I had the same thing with Katawa Shoyo. That really just, it hit me straight in the feels. I'd switch it up. Variety is the spice of life, right? Pretty much. Moving on to the next question. Wait, aren't you going to answer the questions too? I'll take the test after you. I don't want to keep track of both our scores at once. Alright. Question number two. What is your favorite dessert? I don't know. An all-time classic. Who doesn't like chocolate cake? Here's the next question. What is your dream job? Well, I'm going to break the stereotype for once, and because I know she kind of wants to raise kids, stay-at-home parent. I'm with you on that one, but does that really qualify as a job? It's like approaching a fortress. At the beginning, you see nothing, but once you come too close, a bunch of arrows fall down on you. Came very close to tears in a few occasions. I probably will as well. I mean, I'm not too much of an emotional guy, but... Are you questioning the Almighty Magazine? Forget I said anything. How many more questions are there? That's all of them. Which are going to determine what kind of a person I am by three questions? Now, to look up the results. Oh, it says that the results are outlined in the weight loss booklet that came with the magazine. But I already threw that away. What a shame. I'll be at a loss for the rest of my life. But now we get to the best part, the fortune cards. How's that supposed to work anyway? I mean, they're just cards. How can they predict the future? Apparently, there are different schools of thought regarding the use of fortune cards. There's one particular ending that I think is really sad, even though it's technically a good ending. Oh boy. The cards themselves don't know anything. They're just a tool. So the information actually comes from somewhere else. Nightsky probably knows what I mean. I guess so. Don't you fucking spoil it. I will actually ban you. But where, though? Well, one interpretation is that it's our subconscious who gives us the answers that we seek. Similar to how dreams can be interpreted, the interpretation of the cards is very dependent on the person itself and the symbols they recognize in the card's images. We recognize images that are relevant to our lives, and that gives us an idea about ourselves and our current problems. However, that is just the most grounded interpretation out there. People usually associate something more paranormal with fortune cards. One of those explanations is that the cards are our way to communicate with a higher being. a paranormal entity that knows more than we do and can give us subtle nudges using the cards. But I think the male dragons were actually much more interesting than females. Bryce, Remy, and what's the name of small blue dragon? I don't know. And who would that be? The explanations range from ghosts to angelic beings. One even involved humans.
Really?
Yeah, people would say you could communicate with humans this way. And then there was also something they called Higher Self.
Higher Self?
How come you know so much about this? Because I read the article about it. Oh. Okay, what should I draw for you? Why don't I get to be the one who's reading the fortune? Because I paid for this magazine, so the cards are mine. Okay. So, what are my options? I could read your past, present, or future. What is it going to be? Take a look at the present. Understanding our present situation is paramount to understanding the future, as what we do now influences the future that will become our present. Oh, this is interesting. What does it mean? Crossroads are ahead of you. Be wary of your decisions, for the consequences may be dire. Careful actions may have rewarding results, but carelessness could have consequences reaching further than you might think. It's so hard to talk about something without actually spoiling something. Yeah. At least that's what the description says. What's your opinion on this? Well, it's very generic. I was nailed down to a chair for five hours. Yeah, I'm sure that's the reason. I guess that's everything the magazine has to offer. Well, certainly interesting. Shame. I could try to find the diet booklet if you're that desperate to find out the personality test result. Oh, you played a lot. Jesus. Please don't. All right. So, do you have anything interesting going on at the moment? I can't imagine what ambassador life is like. It's been busy. I thought this whole thing would go by quickly and without any mishaps, but now it seems there's always something happening.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I figured I'd come here, do the exchange, and leave again, but apparently it's not that easy.
It never is.
You speak like you've had experience as an ambassador. Well, no, but doing deliveries is similar. People order something, I apply to them, we exchange the product for payment, and then I go back. It's basically the same thing.
Yeah, sure.
But things always go wrong. For example, imagine you have two deliveries to make, and the first one goes smoothly, okay? I'm imagining it very hard right now. Right, so you get to the destination of the second delivery, and they actually check what you're handing them. It turns out you've mixed up the orders, but you already delivered the first one. Well, that's certainly not a pleasant situation to be in. Now you have to go back to the first family you delivered to, who now have probably noticed they got the wrong delivery, and exchange what you gave them for what they actually ordered.
Right.
But it turns out that they didn't mind the mix-up. As a matter of fact, they already started eating what they got instead. I didn't stumble upon this game, I tripped over it and hit my head so hard it was insta-buy, and I don't regret that. It's not so bad that they aren't angry, but now you can't exchange the orders anymore, so you have to fly back to the restaurant to get the second order remade. That happens all the time. As a result, the people waiting for the second order do get angry because their order has to be remade and delivered all over again. And the plot thickens. They complain and of course get their meal comped. The restaurant can no longer sell that first order you still have, so the orders of both families are deducted from your paycheck, and you end up eating nothing but ramen all week again, just so you can make rent this month.
That's unfortunate.
And that's why you always double check your orders, because even a small mistake can have consequences reaching further than you think. Yeah, sometimes we just have to learn the hard way.
I guess so.
I'm popular tonight, Jesus. Anyway, what else have you been up to recently? Ramen aren't that bad.
You remember the stunt flying competition I told you about? Of course, I assume your participation is a given by now? Actually, I'm not so sure about that. I mailed the application earlier today, so hopefully it'll arrive before the deadline. Whenever the metalcore wants this game, the purchase button was hit once again. I think the purchase button needs extensive repairs. I think it does, yeah. There'll be more streams, I heard, so let's see, maybe tomorrow? No, tomorrow I can't. Unfortunately, tomorrow evening I have to work. Unfortunately. And Saturday I'm doing Portal 2 with my friend Boss Hunter. Perhaps a Sunday? If we're not playing Dark Souls then? So actually, I might actually be streaming again on a Monday. I'll be streaming this game again, probably. You'll just have to keep a lookout on my channel. Yeah, be sure to just, you know, press the subscribe button and stuff. Then you'll be notified. Or maybe I should just fly it over myself while showing off a few moves. That is, or you should fly over anyway to make sure you get in. It would be a shame if you couldn't enter because of a technicality. Yeah, I really should drop by. By the way, could you do me a favor? That depends on the favor, I suppose. It's kind of a long story, but there's something I need. You know some people at the police station, right?
Yes?
I think they're in possession of a map related to an underground building they found.
I've heard about that.
Oh, that's great. Maybe you can get them to hand it over? It doesn't even have to be the real thing. A copy would be just fine.
Why?
What do you even need it for? Sounds good, I've already subscribed. Hey bro, thank you very fucking much. Appreciate it, bro. Let's just say I'm interested in doing a little investigation of the place myself. What's so special about it? It's supposed to be a remnant of an earlier civilization, or maybe even something created by humans. Who wouldn't be interested in that? What, pay it? Well, I could think of a few people. An actual human in front of you isn't enough? If I had you all to myself, it might be enough, but since your stay is only temporary, I'll need some other human-related things to keep me busy. How do I even ask for something like that? You could always say that humanity is interested in it.
Honestly, they probably would be.
Could you ask them for me, please? I can try. I won't promise anything, but I can certainly try. Thank you, that means a lot to me. I didn't know you were into archaeology. I wouldn't care as much if it turned out to be just some old building. The whole thing about it being made by humans is what's really interesting.
Why is that?
Well, the myths wouldn't be very mythical anymore if that was the case. We'd have proof. And that's so shortly after finding out that humans are, in fact, real.
Yes, what a time to be alive!
Yes, it's quite lovely. So you believe in all that stuff? Well, belief isn't the right word when you're standing right in front of me, you know? That alone is a miracle. I get excited all over again just thinking about it. Speaking of which, all this excitement made me lose track of the time.
Is it that late already?
Oh, actually, I have places to be, especially if I want to make sure my you have to go out of your way for the map, so keep it in mind. Okay. Especially if I want to make sure my contest application arrives on time. Guess I should be going then, huh? For now, at least. Which characters were your... What's your favorite? For me, it's Remy. He's really a sweetheart. That's kind of a major spoiler already.
Oh, don't fucking tell me you just spoiled me! For now, at least, I certainly wouldn't mind if you stopped to buy again sometime. Will there be any magazines involved? Actually, that magazine doesn't come out that often, so we wouldn't have anything new from them. I could get a different one if you want it, though. Don't bother. Like, no! If you say so. Anyway, I really have to go, so I'll see you around. And we're out the door again. Nothing going on today. Guess I can do whatever. Let me see. We'll go to Bryce and let's see what... Wait, the map. Let's ask him about the map. Yo, Bryce! I need something from you, buddy! Once again, I found myself within the police department, which seemed oddly quiet for this time of day. It didn't take me long to spot Bryce in his office. Hey, Metalcore, what's up? Nothing much, but you told me I could contact you if I remember anything that might help with the investigation. That's right, what do you have for me? I'm not sure if it's worth mentioning, but I have known Reza for a couple of years, so I might know some things about his personality. I see. Well, that's actually helpful than you might think. Mannerisms, habits, all kinds of things would be useful to add to his profile and to get a better idea of him. You know, I'm just about done here for the day, but if you want to discuss it over beer or something, I'd be more than happy. Take that as a spoiler, I'm sorry about that. Nah, dude, you're good, you're good. I don't usually drink, though. That's fine, you don't have to. Or maybe we'll find something you'll like. Do we press him on that? Actually, I find it worrisome that the chief of police prefers to get drunk instead of hearing important information about a case. You're quite right. In my own free time, I do prefer to get drunk instead of dealing with work. If you find that worrisome, maybe you should try out my job sometime. That's not what I meant. Oh, are you coming or not? Alright. Let's fucking do it. YOLO! Drink your liver away. Woo! I mean, I do. And this has actually been a tip that I've gotten from a customer. I do actually. Let me just move the... Get the big camera here. I actually have a bottle of wine in my room. At least I think this is wine. Like I said, I've gotten it as a tip. Let's get smashed! Woo! Yeah, but I actually got that. I haven't cracked it open yet, so I wouldn't know how it fucking tastes. And I'm not that much of a drinker, so... I mean, I might crack it open once I get, like, you know, 1,000 subscribers or something. Me and you guys can help me with that. Want to watch me chug a... if you want to watch me chug a fucking bottle of fucking wine, you know, you can, if you get me to 1,000 subs within, you know, a month or something, I'll be good. Okay, so we're drinking. Not too shabby, I have to admit. And just in time for happy hour. Oh boy. Here we go with the happy hour. Oh, we are going to get fucked up. Oh boy. Do you come here often? Sometimes. Hey, you two. What can I bring you? Just the usual. One generic beer for the chief of police. Sure thing. How about you, Metalcore? It's weird that everyone knows your name. I guess I'll go the same thing. It wasn't too long before the waiter returned with a drinking bowl as wide as it was tall, filled to the brim with a foam-topped dark amber liquid. Carefully, he set it down in front of Bryce, who didn't hesitate to take a big gulp. He brought one for me as well, provided in a glass that seemed more appropriate for my kind. There you go. Just call me if you need anything. Of course. So what was it you wanted to tell me about Reza?
Well, there are a few things. I mean, they're probably not much, but anything might help, right?
That's right. Anything unusual about him, anything that defines his character or stands out about him could help us. How about you tell me what you know about him?
Well, the earliest memory I have of him was when we both went to the same school. We only shared a few classes, though, and a couple of friends. Overall, I'd say he was an above-average student. We didn't talk very often, but he was always very outspoken and never failed to speak up to make his opinions known. He was the kind of person I'd fully expect to become a politician one day, or at least an activist of some sort. That's the impression I got of him. He spoke a lot, but you could also expect him to act on his word. Of course, his nature caused him to clash with others, sometimes even including the school staff, though his genuine enthusiasm also garnered praise from them. He was quite the character. After we graduated, I didn't hear anything about him for a long time. Only some years later, after we found the portal, was I surprised to find out he was the human who would be sent to your world. He had volunteered. It wasn't until I was already here that I actually met him again, however brief our interactions were. But then I already told you everything about what happened prior to the eventual scuffle with Maverick. There's only one thing that stands out to me about those events. In the restaurants where he told me about the letter, he mentioned I would know how to read its secret message. I know he values the use of his own intellect, but when I received the letter later, he apparently fully expected me to remember a random chemistry class we had together years ago in order to see the message. I see, so you did not arrange this beforehand? Not at all, I had no clue. Choose your steps wisely, it's the order that counts.
Shit! Shit, 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 shit!
That is quite peculiar. I know, still wonder what he would have told me if Maverick hadn't interfered when we met at that portal. We do as well, and you can believe that. How is Maverick even allowed to intercept his letter and read it? Could have easily done so since he was in charge of Reza and everything, but he totally shouldn't have. I mean, we wouldn't do anything of the sort with you. Everything he has done in regards to Reza has been a poor show of character.
I suppose so.
In any case, thanks for telling me all of this. You never know when this kind of information could be useful. You know what? I'm going to just... Can I actually properly save here? Okay, just in case, I'm going to properly save the game here, so I can always go back to it if I want to. No problem. Just when I thought an awkward silence might sit in, Bryce spotted the waiter and didn't hesitate to speak up. Hey waiter, bring me another! I hadn't noticed, but when I was talking, Bryce had been busy sipping on his drink. The empty bowl before me was proof of his proficiency, while I had barely touched my own drink. Here you go. Bryce was just about to start on his second, when he suddenly spoke up. You know what? Why don't we have ourselves a drinking contest?
Oh shit, I thought that was gonna happen.
I would, but I don't think I can beat someone like you. How about a handicap then? I'll go easy on you. You're not letting this go, are you? Just having fun. Alright, let's do this! Oh god, he's just... Fair's fair. Considering they don't even have cars, at least I won't have to worry about drinking and driving. The rules are simple. We both get around, then we wait a few moments until the next one so the effects can kick in. Whoever gives up first loses. Sounds easy enough. Sure, just wait until you have a swig of the real stuff and we'll see how easy it is for you. I mean, you are like a 100-pound dragon and I'm like a skimpy human. I'm a biologist, damn it!
Alright, let's do this.
He's bigger than you and like 5-10 times your weight. How do you outdrink that? I lowered his muscles to the bowl before he started guzzling his drink noisily. It was gone in seconds. Certainly, this was going to be tough. My confidence faltered, but there was no turning back now. How did I think I could win in a drinking contest against a freaking dragon? Nevertheless, I grasped the drink, putting on the best show I could while I tried to recreate Bryce's feat.
After the first sip, however, I realized it was very different from any other beer than I had tried before. Yet I persevered through the intense taste until the glass was empty. And this isn't like the water you Americans drink. This is proper alcohol. I probably wasn't as impressive as Bryce had been just moments earlier, but I couldn't afford to show any weakness. My plan was cut short, though, as I set the glass down and an unusually strong aftertaste hit me, causing me to make a face. How'd you like it? This is some really strong stuff. Told ya, you better know beforehand how much you can take or it'll hit you harder later on. Wanna give up already? I think we can go for an... It's not just that, but we'll see, Miroslav.
God damn it!
First one. Another one. Okay, so now he's just taunting me, like, soon enough. You feel it? Feel the bus kicking in? Don't lie to me, I can see it in your face. Unless that's blushing I see and not the alcohol. That's a buzz, okay. That's what I thought. Anyway, how'd you like it here so far? I mean, compared to wherever it is that you came from. How could I not love this, dude? We'll see how much you like it when I've drunk you under the table. Waiter, bring us another round! Coming right up. Here you go. Having ourselves a little contest, are we? You know how it goes. That I do. Be careful, Metalcore. He's a pro. I mean, I'm not going to drink this guy under the table. Who the fuck is this? Zith. Did I hear something about a contest? You're one ugly motherfucker. Although you do look kind of cool. Maybe. Up to your old shenanigans, I see. Now, don't spoil the fun. I don't go around telling people about what you're up to either. Point taken. Enjoy. Of course he wouldn't have challenged me if he wasn't confident he would win. Guess I'll just have to try my best. You actually pronounced my name correctly? Most people have problems doing that? Good job. Well, the thing is, I'm not an American. Or an Englishman, or from some English-speaking country. I'm actually Dutch, so... I mean, pronouncing, you know, the more European names is not that hard. So, I usually don't have trouble, you know, pronouncing names such as Miroslav. You know, it's pretty easy. I went first last time, so it's your turn now. As I put the glass to my lips and started swallowing the dark amber liquid, I was struck by how much more difficult this round was compared to the first. One thing that always puzzled me about seasoned drinkers was the sheer amount of liquid they could ingest without issue. Keeping it down, however, was a much different question. But this contest wasn't about keeping it down. There, your turn. Did I see you struggling there for a second? Let's see how you do. I've had much more than this before. As for my turn, let me demonstrate. Once again, he consumed his drink, though his swigs were noticeably slower than before. His resolve was also fading, though not as fast as mine had. As he clearly held the advantage, was there any way I could still turn this around? There. Now let me ask you a question. I know you wanted to tell me all the stuff about Reza, but was that the only reason you wanted to meet with me? Oh, here we need to tread carefully. Shit. Okay, this is where I save. Okay. Doesn't it hurt to have friends in high places? I see. Waiter, next round. Coming. There you go. Thanks. How are you holding up? Just fine, thanks for asking. If you say so, good luck. Was it your turn or is it my turn? It's yours.
All right.
Bottoms up. By now it was obvious that Bryce was faltering, though he still was sparing much better than I was. He even had to take a break in the middle of his beer, unable to down it in one go.
Now, it's yours.
He was a lot heavier than me, and even though his bowls held far more liquid than my glasses, how did I think I'd stand a chance against him? When I picked up my glass, I didn't have feeling in my fingers anymore. I had to pause a few times, but in the end I made it, though I wasn't sure how much more I could take. So, what do we do now? Wait for you to throw up so I win? Hey, you wish. I could see you're close. Just a question of time now, Sonny. Can I ask you a question? Go ahead. Like, why are you brown? Damn it, you don't just... Damn it, you don't just ask someone why they're brown. Don't you have, like, differently colored people where you come from? Or do they all look like you? You seriously look like a chocolate cream cake. Delicious chocolate cream cake. Can I taste you? Waiter, next round. More beer. There you are. Literally, the dragon looked at me, seemingly unable to focus. I could see he was hitting his limit, but so was I. Maybe if I just held out a little longer. Whose turn is it even? I don't even know anymore. I'm positive it's yours. Damn it! Very well. Bottoms up. I could still win this. I had to wait a few moments after each sip in order to continue, but I did not give up until eventually the glass was empty. So suck on this, you scaly bastard. For the first time I could see something in his eyes other than his always present confidence. Was it disbelief? Or insecurity? I guess my feet caught him off guard as he seemed genuinely impressed. If nothing else, it showed me that even his own conviction was cracking now. I could totally win this. Yeah, that little emotional manipulation, that little mental manipulation there. You're cute. I like you. I really do. But as sure as heck, I'm not gonna let you win. He was struggling. It became more and more obvious as he tried to swallow the liquid in his bowl bit by bit. He stopped at one point, panting heavily. I considered taking a cheap shot at him, but as he had refrained from doing so during my turn, I wasn't going to start now. There. I was getting tired. I could hear Bryce's voice, but I couldn't make out the individual words anymore. I decided to rest my eyes. Just for a little bit. Ow. I think I fell. Hey, are you okay? You fell down and looked kind of messed up. Shut up. I'll mess you up if you don't get out of- you get your face out of my face. Fucking bitch. It's not over, damn it. I can see that. Ready for another round or do you give up? Bring it on, bitch. Actually, you know, once you're lying on the ground, you better stop. Does that mean I win? I didn't say that. You know, it was fun watching you and all, but you've both had enough for the evening. I think you'd better leave now, after you've come out from under the table, of course. Alright, I'll be going then. Wait a minute. What is it? Maybe you should go with him, just to make sure he gets home safely and doesn't do anything stupid, you know? It's kind of an unspoken rule here that whoever is his drinking buddy does so. When I looked over to him, I discovered that Bryce had passed out for the moment. This could prove difficult. Just leave, like, bye! Come on, let's get you home, you big bastard! Let's dump some water on his ass. Is that you, Metalcore? Where am I? Still in the bar. Come on, let's get you home, you big wuss.
Oh, he's calling him a wuss. Okay.
I awoke looking at an unfamiliar ceiling. For a moment, I wondered where I was, before the events of last night all came back to me. As I got up and looked around, I realized that I had apparently slept on the floor. Where am I? This is not my apartment. Oh, there he is. Hello. Guess I must have passed out after I got Bryce home. Hey, Bryce. Wake up, fatty. The dragon moved and let out a groan before he opened his eyes. Just as you do occasionally, I bet. Damn, my head. Why are you even here? Guess I must have passed out after I escorted you home. Oh, right, after a little game. You remember who won? I don't even know, but you stood your ground, and I respect that. You didn't do anything funny while I was out, did you? The dragon rose from the couch with a nice morning stretch, rubbed his eyes, and held his head high as he let out a grunt and a big yawn. That whole contest was stupid. Well, it was your idea. At least I knew when to stop. At least it's not like you were egging me on the whole time. Wait, actually, that is exactly what happened. No, you're right. This was a bad idea all around. That's easy to say after the fact. Yeah, and I clearly held you there against your will and made you drink too, right? You may as well have. You know, as an ambassador, I can't really say no to a social meeting with the chief of police. So when it's not my fault, it's your job's fault. That's just brilliant. It's everyone's fault but your own. Well done, Metalcore. Lol. You know what? Maybe you should be leaving about now. Yeah, I guess I should.
Chapter 3, Superstition. Okay, I am actually going to have to call it a night here, because it is currently 11:11, actually. And I've been streaming for almost 3.5 hours. I've been streaming for a fucking long time, okay? Boop! So we're just going to, we're going to call it a day here, or a night, or a whatever. Because like I said, I've been streaming for way too fucking long already. So yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. I really, you know what I'm going to do? This was something I was going to do already. This is what I said I was going to do. We are going to go over to the store page. We are going to go with the digital deluxe upgrade. And we're going to order it on stream. Okay, so I'm going to black this out for a minute, just so I can, you know, do all my payment and stuff. And, so we're just going to do that real quick. Yes, I agree. Continue. It's only 7 euros, so it's not that much. I mean, why the heck not, you know, support the developer. See, did that work? Sadly, I joined too late. Well, I mean, the VOD's gonna be on YouTube after this, so you can watch it back if you want to. I just need to copy this stuff over real quick. I need this. I need this. Log in. There's my bank account. Next. Let me see, I need to do. Okay, it's working. Come on. Do it. It's taking its sweet time, I can tell you that. Come on. Go through, you fuck. And if we now go to our library,
you'll see I have the Angels with Scaly Wings Digital Deluxe Edition Extras. Can I download that in some way? Oh, I guess it'll do that by itself once it's... It'll probably do it in an update or something. Okay, so we're just going to exit out of this. I sure as hell am excited for the next stream, that's for sure. Yeah, like I said, it's most likely going to be a Monday. Monday, same time, 8 p.m. Central European Standard Time. Central European Time, which is GMT plus 1. So if you just look up 8 p.m. CET on Google, you should be able to find what it is on your location. And of course, I will just be making the live stream announcement, so that will contain a countdown to when it's starting. So, like I said, thank y'all fuckers so much for watching. I hope you will be joining the next stream. By the way, I have my Twitch channel down in the description, all the way at the bottom. That's my Twitch channel. I'm going to be streaming primarily on there, though. So if you want to see more streams from me, go follow there as well. And of course, subscribe to my YouTube, because there will be highlights from those streams on here as well. So yeah, go do all that stuff. Have a very great rest of your evening doing whatever. And I'll see y'all dragon fuckers in the next stream. Peace.